Suddenly the sky erupts. Flames alert the trees, spread to fallen leaves. Gather by me. Wait if I'm on fire. How am I so deep in love when I dream of dying? I never feel so loved. I've been having dreams, splashing in the summer stream, tripping, I fall in. I wanted it to happen. My body turns to ice, crushing weight of paradise. Solid block of gold, lying in the cold. I feel right.
Hell yeah. Well, that was some shit. You're still muted, I think.
Yeah, that was just me flying the three intro in the park. Yeah, what's up, know. Clyde Flies?
Oh, so it's just us.
What's up, APOC? APOC, why don't you jump in here? It's been a while since you've been on the shit show.
He wants to know why the fuck Enya's sister's mouth is raping your ears. Hey, Clyde Boys! It's me and you, bud. Cheers to that.
Cheers. The Lone Rangers.
Yeah, it's a late show. I had a fucking Christmas party that was fucking awesome for work. And, I'm almost in no condition to do this, I guess, but...
Well... Yeah. Sometimes you gotta get drunk and go on stream.
Yeah, and sometimes I gotta fall asleep, which people have plenty of memes of that, so. It happens, but.
Nice Hello Kitty shit you got going on right beside you, bud.
Oh, that's where I'm sleeping tonight, after the party.
Oh, nice.
Yeah. I actually, at this point, I might actually just put my head down and sit in my chair and put my face straight down. That thing just came out of the wash. It's probably still nice and warm.
Oh, Clyde man. Flies getting back up in the air, buddy.
Hell yeah. Fuck yeah.
Can't all my quads are fucked right now. I need to spend some TLC on each one of them. I took 5 of them out to the field. 3 of them fucking didn't even work. I don't know why the fuck, but... One of them today, I tried to plug one of them in, and it fucking worked. No fucking problem. So I don't know what the fuck.
Yeah, we were actually, before the stream, we were watching a video about how fucked my quad's flying. Like, it's a great quad, it just, something's up. Like, it's not good. And there's no way I can fly with those fucking geese again. They're already gone.
You know, cheers, APOC. He said he just shot a nice sized booger out of his nose.
Fucking APOC. Hey, he hasn't said fuck our couch yet, at least.
Yeah.
Oh, man. So, what's your plan for the week? What are you doing tomorrow? Where are you flying at tomorrow?
Tomorrow? What is tomorrow? Fucking Wednesday?
Yep.
I'll probably just do some repairs and hopefully go fly at a local park just to make sure my shit's working. And then I'll be doing my my live edit, live stream. I still got to figure out what I'm going to do on that, what I'm going to edit. I got tons of fucking footage.
Yo, you should actually, you should do like a giveaway and have somebody give you some of their footage and then...
I want to do that for my, like, when I hit 1,000 subs, rather than giving something away, I want to, like, do an edit for someone, like Zorro did. I thought that was fucking really fucking cool.
Dude, fuck yeah. I think, like, the editing style differences between you and Zorro, like, you guys are killing it with editing, but you have such
but
a
it's
different
so different
style.
Yeah. Like, yeah, I agree.
That'd be dope. Dude, I hope I win. Do I have to sub to you at 1,000, or can I already be subbed when... Shit, I've been subbed to you since you had, like, what, Like
less than 200, I bet.
Dude, it's been a while, man. We've been shooting this shit for over a year. Well over a year.
Hell yeah, dude. Dude, I gotta find my cigarettes. They fucking disappeared somewhere.
Do I have to play out?
Oh, there they are. Found them. Dozer, knock it off. Lay down. My dogs are getting gay with each other.
Hey, they do that sometimes.
It's even worse, their father-son.
Oh, so it's like a dominance thing. Let's do a reverse giveaway when I get to 1,000.
Yeah, someone gives me their quad.
Fuck yeah.
Dude, the funny thing is, so like I was telling you about the UAV Futures giveaway that I'm waiting on the results for. All the like Discord, dude, they're hating on me so fucking bad for my edit. Some dudes are like, I think the editing is going to work against some people in this case. And Stu, like, literally, like, dropped what he wants out of the video. You know, he dropped this, like, scoring rubric. Yeah. And it says, like, storytelling, you know, different camera angles, sound effects, different locations. And basically, that's all my edits anyways, you know?
Yeah.
And it's kind of cool because, like, me and Spoonie J were shooting footage for the edit before we even had the contest, you know, get announced.
No shit.
So we were like super fucking prepared.
Yeah, no, that came out dope. I played again here, but you already have like a couple million views, so people have seen it. All five people watching have already seen it.
Exactly. The drones changed my life video. I know you guys have seen it.
Later, Clyde. I hope you come back, buddy.
See you, Clyde.
No, I don't know. It's like I feel like he dropped the criteria. He wanted something well put together, well composed, that worked.
He wanted something that he could share with the community, you know, and I feel like I put a piece of content out that can do that. The other ones are really good and the stories are good, but there's like the production value is lacking, and I think that's what he was looking for, is something that he can put on his channel and do, because like what the judges were Fat Shark, Armatan, and TBS, so, you know, like, They know quality, so...
Yeah, exactly. I mean, they're all quality company, and they're not going to put out and be like, oh, hey, this guy won, and it's some bunk bullshit, so...
Yeah, exactly, dude. Dude, I spent so much fucking time on that edit, like, it was ridiculous. I remember I was, like 2 weeks, like, 6 to 8 hours a day, at least, behind the computer.
Mm-hmm. And you could tell, it's a fucking great edit, so I don't know why anybody would hate on it, unless they can't edit. And even me, I can't edit, and I'm not hating on the fucking video.
That's why it was funny, like, when he was hating on me, because, like, it was, like, three dudes. They were, like, talking back with each other. And you could tell, like, somebody's got to hate, you know, the top dog. That's just how it fucking goes.
Mm.
Like, yep. Regardless of what you're doing, like.
Mm. Well, when's that, that video's coming out in a couple hours? Or that's usually his time frame that he drops in.
Well, so... There's only a couple people here, so I don't mind talking about it. But yeah, me and him have been emailing back and forth, and I sent him the video clip for him to upload to his channel. I sent him the thumbnail. And I'm just waiting for him to drop his next video, and I believe I'm like 99% sure his next video will be the announcement video, which is awesome.
Fuck yeah, we've been waiting on that too, because he's been on vacation.
Dude,
with the family.
Yeah, he went to China. The contest ended November 1st, so it's been like a month and a half at this point, you know?
Yeah, it's been a bit. But, nah, dude, I hope you win, just because you're one of my homies, so it'd be awesome to see you win. But also, that was like a great, great fucking video. Like, that's one of the videos that you can show people that don't fly, and they're like, well, why do you do this? And they're like,
that's kind of was my goal when I was making it. I wanted it to be relatable to FPV, but I wanted it to be relatable to somebody who's never even seen a drone before, you know?
Yep. It was funny too, because I've shown that video to so many different people. Like, I mean, I deal with people of like all different walks of life, And they're like, oh, what do you do in your free time? And I'm like, oh, I do this. And I bring up that video now instead of
Hell yeah, dude.
just showing them one of my flight videos or whatever. And they're like, oh, Jesus, like, this is fucking crazy. And it's like, yeah, I don't fly that good. But no,
Dude, like some of those shots that Spoonie got when he was going through the fucking the little crack in the canyon wall, that shit was sick.
Yeah, that I would not have fucking got.
I wouldn't have done that. That's why I like flying with Spoonie, is because he'll do shit like that and it'll push me to step it up. But he's been flying half the time I have. Simulator, yeah. that's where it's at.
Yeah, because you guys have only been flying for like a year, huh?
Yeah, I've been flying for like two. He's been flying for like a year.
Yeah. Oh, I know you've been flying for a good bit longer than him. But, dude, he's killing it for a year. And he got picked up by Hot Dog, too, so...
And he just got a DSLR, like, good things for him, like...
Fuck yeah, dude. Well, hey, cheers to Spoonie.
Yeah, cheers to Spoonie. Fucking, he's gonna be, you know, he's co-winner of this contest. So...
Dude, I didn't even know there was a contest until, like, I saw your video.
That's what I'm saying. Like, I wouldn't have even known about it if it wasn't for Spoonie. Like, he was the one who was like, hey, man, have you seen the contest that Stu's doing? I'm like, no. And he, like, showed me, and I, like, instantly I was like, that's what I do. I could do that.
Like, I can do things.
Yeah, I could do that.
Oh, that's sick. All right, so... Inquiring minds want to know. We got six people watching. Nobody's asked this, so I'm going to ask it. What do you have planned next that you haven't done in the fucking cliffs? What is one thing that you haven't done that you want to do? Because that is like the hot shit fucking place to
fly. I want to build a video repeater so I can put it like at the peak and fly like super deep in like crevices. I think that might be the next on my list of things.
Nice. Fuck yeah.
Because I think that's like the only limiting factor. Like, you'll be on like a nice long mountain run and you'll just dip down a little bit too low and you'll just like get some shitty video and you know that your crossfire is good, but you just fuck can't see, so you pull out. But if you could see, dude, you could get some crazy like killer lines that you couldn't get otherwise.
Fuck
it.
Yeah.
Doesn't even have to be that high, you know? Someone was saying like fucking tie it to a balloon and that would absolutely work. You know, 100 feet above your head, that would open up line of sight like dramatically for a lot of spots.
Oh, fuck yeah.
But even strapped to the fucking Mavic, you know, that fucker flies for 20 minutes. You can get 5 runs in that, you know?
Oh, hell yeah. Actually, that's what we should do tonight, is we should interview each other. And I'll just keep asking you questions and then we'll switch.
Okay.
All right. In those... Going back to the cliffs, what was the gnarliest thing that you made it through? Well, like, what was something that you didn't think you were going to make it through, and then you pulled through, and then you were just like, fuck it, I'm good. Like, that's it for today. My luck's good.
Probably. Oh, Zora, get the fuck out of here. Mavics are dead? Shit, I'm about to buy one of those fucking... Mavic cameras on a stick.
You're buying a Mavic that can't fly tomorrow.
Mm-hmm. Yes, and if you guys don't know about that new DJI Pocket thing, I'm going to go pick one of those up to test out for all you fuckers.
Oh, what up, MacTac?
MacTac, you're a fucking savage.
Yo, if anybody has questions, post them in the
play
chat.
Play a MacTac video.
I got more questions for you, man.
Oh, okay, man. Fucking ask up.
All right, well, you didn't answer the last one. What was, like, the butt pucker moment that you made it through?
But probably my biggest butt pucker cliff moment was flying with the base jumpers. There was this one time where, like, I, like, got in front of him, and I, like, turned around to line up my shot, and all I see is him coming straight the fuck at me. And I just kind of a little roll and fucking kind of roll around him, but I was a lot closer to comfort than I would have liked, but... Not as close as fucking Virgin shooting the gap. Yeah. Zora says we gotta drink when someone says fly. So, fly.
No. Dude, I've been drinking all night. I've been at the Christmas party.
Well, then I guess I gotta handicap on you then.
Yeah, a little bit. Jesus. This is going to be one of those nights where I forget to shut the stream down and I fucking go to bed. You were here for that, weren't you?
Yeah.
Well, the first
one. Nardog, Waxfire, Brian Kirby.
What up? Oh, is Brian Kirby here from BQE.io? Oh, wait, hold on. I think I actually have a sticker on my bucket because I've been out just sticking them fucking everywhere. I put one on a urinal tonight, but I forgot to take a picture.
Sick.
So those people are going to know about BQE.io.
Have you guys heard?
If they don't know, now they know.
Burb is not dead.
What up, Dufour? Okay.
The fuck is Burb?
Dude, Burbs are not real.
Burb's not real.
Nope. Okay, what is the closest you've ever got to a tree without eating shit and regretting it? And why do you regret being that close?
Asking these questions. This shit happens like fucking multiple times a day, and you're like, what's this time? I'm like, fuck.
Oh, fucking.
Basically, are you asking the worst time I got stuck in a tree? Is that what you're asking me?
No, I was asking the worst time that you didn't get stuck in a tree, but fuck, dude.
Probably actually recently. You know that one park that I fly, that I did the Misfits challenge where I go up the slide?
Yep.
Well, there's a big tree in the middle of that area, and I was like just ripping around. I'm like, fuck, I'll power loop this tree, and I like power loop the tree, and dude, I like, whoop, it's a very, very tip top. Whoop, it's like a fucking 60-foot tree too, and I like tapped it. What's okay. The closest you've been to eating shit, literally?
No, I'm asking the questions here. What is the closest that you've been to eating shit, literally?
Have you seen Step Brothers where they don't want to walk home the certain way?
I assume that we've all been pretty close. Before you answer, actually, how much of your beer do you have left? Oh, all right, right on.
I got a few more.
All right,
should we just go beer for beer?
Yeah, we'll go beer for beer because Bone said fly, fly, fly. So no, kill it.
No. Oh.
All right, so we both have to go get beers, huh?
Put a MacJack video on. Play us out.
All right, yep. I'll play us both.
That dude is a ripper and deserves a feature.
All right, right on. All right, I got this, I think. I didn't play him out. What the fuck? What happened? Dude, I didn't play out, bud. I'm still looking for the video and... Here, you can commentate and I'm gonna do that.
Is the video playing, guys? Stymie, what's up, Stymie? Double A, how you guys doing tonight? Did Gravy fail? The Gravy fail? Did he just play the trailer? If you guys don't know who MacTac is, definitely go. Oh shit! Go head over to his fucking channel. ghosts making flying noises? Yes. Ghosts are making noises, Zoro. They're saying Zoro under their breath. Let's all cheers to Wombat. I hear he's having a rough time. Rough on the butthole time tonight. We love you. Before, much love. You won't regret it. MacTac is a ripper. He's, me and him are side by side with 1,000 sub race.
All right, and the back.
Oh, yep, hit the like button on here, everybody. Share it with your grandmas. Late night nonsense. All right, so Gravy.
Yeah.
What was your first quad?
Next question. It was
That's an easy one.
Actually, I think it was a Gepar C Leopard.
Oh, okay, dude. I really almost bought that frame. I almost did. I don't know what kept me from doing it. I think I bought the space one instead.
Yeah. Dude, it was fun. I flew it in angle. Actually, I flew it in horizon mode. And I was like, dude, I can do rolls and flips, line of sight. Fuck yeah. And then, and then I got a tiny whoop, and I was like, well, I can do that with this, too.
Dude, so did you go straight into acro? Did you fly horizon? Did you go FPV first, line of sight first?
No, I went.
Let me ask you this. Did you go even before, like, mini quads, did you get, like, shitty little fucking Walmart drones?
No, like, I've been flying, like, I flew nitro gassers as a kid.
Okay. So you got a head start.
Yeah, like, I flew line of sight with those, but they're way fucking different.
Yeah, everybody, like, in the feed, drop your first quad. I kind of want to know. Mine was an LHI 220 that I built. Basically a wizard, but I wanted to build it, so I saw what came with the wizard kit, and I was like, okay, I'll just buy one of each of those, and maybe it'll work.
And Zora just asked, that is a frame for girls, and that's why I got it and why Chris didn't. No, like,
Zora,
like,
when are we going to have a Zora frame? That's what I want to know.
Dude, imagine how
it's just going to be, no, it's just going to be a dildo with, like, 2 coat hangers, and that's it.
Actually, you know what? That's funny. I'm going to bring up one of these videos. Here's a video that not many people have seen. Because of childhood or child profanity, I guess is. But I don't know if that's what they want. But I'll bring up the video. Because he said I fly motorcycles and yeah, I
the ZMR 250, the old what is that, the QAV, the knockoff.
Yeah,
that's what I ran. The LHI 220s though with the QAVR knockoff.
All right. So
it's going to be an edible frame. Fucking dead.
An edible frame? Yeah, it is.
Just a big old fucking, like, Jolly Rancher shaped as a dildo.
It's going to be made of fucking just straight Montana paint. Straight Montana paint. Paint on paint on paint. I can't see what he's saying, so,
We want a big jerky edible frame. Absolutely.
Is that what you want? Yeah, no, I still want a painting.
Because when you're out in the field and you just want to keep flying, but you're hungry, you could sacrifice your quad.
I want to go out flying, and I just want to have, like, a little portrait that Zoro painted, and I could just put it down next to my bag and lean it up and just look over and just kind of, yeah, no, I got to fly good. Zoro's here.
Yeah, exactly. It's like instant inspiration, dude. Or it's like an instant badge of legitness. If somebody, like, with authority comes by and they're like, what the fuck are you doing here flying your toys? You just hold that up and you say nothing, and their mind will be changed.
It's like when that kid shows up at the girl's house that he really likes when he's in fucking middle school, and he holds the boombox over his head, which is now like an iPad.
That's all it does. You don't have to say words. You just...
you hold up the picture of Zorro and just music plays.
Fuck yeah. Let's give a shout out to Zoro because what, a year ago he had what 80 subs, and now he's at what are you at, Zoro?
3,000 something. Hold on, let me bring
that more up. Than that. I think it's more than that. Yeah, I don't want to get it wrong, so I'm not going to even guess.
Hold on, I'm going to get the accurate number. 3,530 fucking three.
Cheers, brother. Like, that's fucking badass.
Dude, a year? Dude, yeah, I can't even break 600.
Because of his fucking, just his whole demeanor, and that's awesome, dude. Anytime Zoro comes on the shit show, it's always fucking fun. We miss you, Zoro. Get the fuck on here. We know you're not doing anything. You're eating some boiled peanuts.
Yeah, he is. Oh, and I'll pay, like, anything that you paint for me, dude. I'll pay you whatever, dude, you want. Like, Zoro, I just want
to
have.
I want to talk to you about, actually, like, I want to pay you to commission, like, a piece. Because, dude, I love your fucking work. And it's, like, I want to, like, have a West Side thing done. And, like, my whole, like, painted graffiti logo, you know, text, that's exactly your kind of style. You know, and you've got the California swag, and that's what I'm about. California swag living in Colorado. Don't hate me too hard.
All right. So I have not. Oh, wait. Actually, I can. There's video apparently that people are posting from the Christmas party. Yeah, I'm not watching that. but I will bring this up and let me drag this down. And Zoro said, I used to fly motorcycles and. I make sure that's.
I used to fly those too. Sometimes I would get hurt on the landing.
Oh, I wish. Let's see
how. Zoro shaving his head. Tell him to just shave a big dick in the back.
All right, so here's me. About a year ago, I think this is right before my daughter was born, and this is me not riding in the town I live in, but. This is me leaving work.
Holy shit.
Holy shit.
Dude, it's been flames. Holy fuck. Holy shit.
That was a good time. So that was me.
That's fucking funny.
That was me flying motorcycles, and that's what Zoro wanted? Huh? Is that what he wanted? Yeah, I think that's what he wanted. Alright, what do you got? More questions. What do you got, bud?
Yes, so, okay, so your first quad, the JIP.
Yep.
Well, what was your first radio?
DX6i.
Oh, you poor, poor bastard. No, I'm just kidding.
Well, I was flying CB helis, too, and I got one.
Yeah, I get it. Anybody who flew helis...
I got one hanging right there, too.
Yeah, dude, anybody who flew helis fucking ran Spectrum.
Mm-hmm.
All my heli buddies ran Spectrum.
Oh, all right, keep going. What do you got?
Yep. Have you ever had to get wet to retrieve a quad?
Yes, and yes, I have, and I have video proof.
Pull it up. I don't believe you.
All right. And it was the V1 Alien book.
Oh, shit.
Oh, God. Did you guys know that the UFDA Crew shit show is live right now?
Really? Dude, yeah. I'm going to share that link. Everybody in here, you needs to do the same.
Dude, I have to scroll back so far to fucking bring this video up. But
yeah, I like that. When you gotta search for a video, but you know, like, you're like, oh shit, I gotta show somebody this video, and it takes you a minute, you know, like, man, I got a lot of fucking videos.
And it's a great.
I think I'm coming up on like 200 like YouTube uploads.
Oh, dude, I have to go back and see how many I fucking have up.
How many uploads do you guys have to your channel? MacTech, I wanna know how many you have.
Alright.
You're right there with me on sub count.
Alright, so here it is. This video obviously worked. This is back in like the box goggles days. I gotta get to. There we go. It's the town river. It's coming up. Just some random branch fucking poked out of nowhere and knocked me right back in the fucking river.
I just dropped it in the UAV Futures Discord.
Oh, hell
hopefully
yeah.
We'll get some of those fucking... Those dudes are having lunch right now, so they'll be up.
Actually...
Well, this sucks.
There you go. Here's me going in the fucking town river.
Yeah.
I forgot it was in the beginning.
Son of a bitch. Miles from where I dwell. Oh, she's an angel. I gotta get this one back. What the fuck?
No quad left behind.
If I fall in here and drop my GoPro, I'll be losing my shit. Oh, fucking glorious. Oh.
And there it is.
I'm watching the video. Oh, damn, dude. Yeah, I'm watching the video with, like, on the stream, so it's a second behind, but. Hell yeah. Okay, what's the highest you've had to get to retrieve a quad? Figuratively or literally?
Well, the funny thing is, like, I don't fly high or drunk. I never have. Like, I've had maybe, like, half a beer and flown a pack.
Have you had to climb a fucking tree then?
Yeah, I had one of my surgeries done on my spine, and I went out and flew. It was probably like a month into me flying acro with proper, like, a proper setup, and I wound up trying to do inverted yaw spins, which was like, I shouldn't have been fucking around with those at all at that point. I should have been learning the basics, I guess. But I'm like, well, fuck it, I've seen people do it on YouTube, so I want to try it too. No, I did it, and I pulled out of it, and I punched out right into a fucking tree, and the quad wound up catching fire, because we were shaking the tree a bunch, and we were trying to get the quad down, but it was just sawing right through the fucking battery leads. So, it was maybe 30 seconds into my flight, and the quad was 30 feet up in a tree, which is ironic. But, yeah, I climbed a tree, and... I was pretty close. I was maybe like 10 or 15 feet out, and I was shaking the fucking branch, thinking I was getting the fucking quad down. I wasn't getting the quad down. I was helping it catch fire. So so the battery blew up, like, right by my fucking
head. Fucking sick. Yeah. I've never had a battery explode.
Oh, I've had one explode, and that was it. And from now on, when I go up in a tree, I'll throw shit at it, but I'm not going up there that fucking close.
And I've had one ESC go up. One. And it's because it hit a fucking gate. I know it hit the fucking gate, like, head on.
Well, here's something.
Let's give some shout-outs, dude. We got a bunch of people in the chat. Oh, Artemis fuck Prime, yeah. Fucking Captain Calgary. Hey, Aaron. What's up, buddy? Reaper X.
What up, Reaper?
Josh Withrow.
What up, Josh? What up, Waxfire?
Waxfire's been in the chat a minute.
Oh, yeah. Just going, throwing it
and
back.
Yes, I got to come visit MagTac in Canada. That's like another Long Rangers fucking paradise.
Dude, I feel like UFGA crew needs to make a fucking Canadian appearance. We need to get up there.
Dude, we just need to just do the fucking the tea party, dude. I'm coming down for sure, like 4th of July weekend at Gravy's house. That's all I know. For next year. That's about my plans for next year so far.
So basically the whole week, except for the day of 4th of July, because I have a family party I gotta go to. Dude, I hope Skidoo shows up, and apparently he showed up. He's saying go to bed, you fucks. But, no, anybody that wants to come out and chill, like, it's just an open place. I'm going to work on it way in advance so that way we can accommodate a bunch of people, because I know there's going to be fucking lot more people than were here last year, but...
Dude, now with the shit show going on and, like, dude, like, you have steady traffic on your channel, dude, that's, like, one thing. That's honestly the reason I started doing my live streams is, dude, the live streaming just creates so many watch time hours. Because all you fucks don't ever watch all of anyone's videos, and that's okay because nobody... does all the time, and that's fine. But for some reason, we can trick your brains into thinking that this is worth watching when it's really just fucking two FPV idiots talking about nothing.
And now we have 21 people watching
me, exactly.
Me and you drink beer and get stoned.
Exactly. And we build the YouTube channel.
No, but I mean, the whole thing is, like, with the Tea Party, it's like, I don't care where you're from or who you are, how good you are, it doesn't matter. Just
No, that's my fucking just life motto. Like, I don't give a fuck how good you are at anything. Like, as long as you got a good attitude, like, we can be friends. If you want to be good at something, that's like, I can't be friends with anybody that doesn't have a passion for anything. Like, I don't care what you have a passion for, just have a passion for fucking something.
Yep.
Like, get excited about fucking something.
No, that's, and that was kind of like my whole, like, it started off, it was like me, Bot, and Apoc making the joke, like, oh, we're going to sit in a fucking pool, and we're going to have an RC boat that dumps tea into the fucking pool. Hey, it's the Boston Tea Party. And then we were going to hang out. And then it turned into, like, fucking droners coming out. The whole episode is coming out on, I believe it's the second week in January. Like, it turned into this big fucking thing. I never thought it was going to get as big as it was. And all these people showed up. Everybody wanted to come up. Everybody wanted to hang out. And it's like, dude, that's fucking awesome. Like, everybody had a fucking blast. The kids had a blast.
And yeah, dude, like, the footage I saw from it, it looked like a fucking blast, you know?
You know, the funny thing is that, like, I kind of slacked on the L on my edit because it
was
at my house.
Dude, that's when you know you had a fucking good time, is when your edit comes out less okay than you originally planned because you had such a good time, you didn't shoot everything you wanted to.
Well, it's not only that, but I want to drop it, like, in the dead of fucking winter for all the people, because a lot of the people were from, like, the Northeast that came up, so when it's freezing cold, it's like, hey, remember this time in July? So I'm not putting that edit out until, like, maybe, like, late January, early February, something like that. But, dude, anybody that wants to come up, if you love flying and you're not a cunt, you're welcome in our house.
Even if you are, you just better be ready to take everyone's shit.
Yeah. I mean, it was just such a fucking great time. Like, we chilled in the backyard. We had a huge-ass, like, 30-foot-tall bonfire going. People are flying. We're all sitting under a fucking tent. The weather was, like, it was actually looking like shit. It was, like, when everybody was driving up from, like, the Baltimore-Philly area, it was pouring fucking rain. Like, we were
Yeah, dude, I remember some of the footage you showed me. It was just fucking street dumping.
Yeah, there were, like, 10 of us underneath a fucking pop tent. And we were all, like, just hanging out there, drinking beers, like, smoking a couple of fucking things. And you could see the fucking lightning, like, striking all around the house. And I'm like, yo, this weekend's fucked. Like, everybody came up here for nothing. And then it just cleared up.
Dude, like, that's fucking sick.
Dude, it was awesome. We had 10 of us in that little ass, like, sand pit that I fly in. And, I mean, we have plenty of spots up here that we can go to and rip for fucking hours, and nobody's
gonna say, and then come and chill at your house at night and shit, right?
Yep.
That's kind of what I imagined. That's what I would fucking do. Dude, a West Coast one, I'd be down with that. Yeah, MacTech, so I'm from Southern California, so anything on the West Coast, I'd be down with. But don't plan 4th of July, because that's fucking, it's a tea party.
Yo, Skadoosh, you know my door is always open for you, homie.
Oh, Skadoosh is in the chat. What's up, buddy?
Nah, he's been here. Mary, Tornado Girl.
I need to look at the chat.
Nah, I know. I'm slacking on it, too. I'm looking up at it now. Mary, I'm trying door to is always open.
Think of cool shit to ask you.
Dude, just fucking run with it, man.
So let's see.
Dude, why is my phone vibrating? What are you asking me?
What is your favorite all-time quad to ever fly, that you've ever flown, that you're like, holy fuck, like, I just want to fly this every time I pick up sticks? Nardog, there's already a Colorado quad camp out. If you guys don't know about that, then you missed out. We need to pull that fucking video up, dude.
You know,
my fucking quad camp out. Let me get the link.
All right, my favorite quad and
yeah, dude. Your favorite quad.
All right, it's my favorite quad is the BQE 210. Bottom out.
Okay, with what battery, what motors?
1300 CNHL 4S. The Hyperlite 2307 2522s. And
did some primos,
I'm just kidding. All KISS V1.
KISS? Okay. That's more what I was wondering.
V1 KISS. Dude, I love the BQE 210. Like, it's one of those quads.
I want to build. I'll tell you this. I've been stuck on flying my Epics, you know, for my mid range shit, and then my flow rides for the tree bashing. But dude, that 5AF, I'm like about to fucking hit by just because I like the setup. It's got the replaceable arms.
Mm-hmm.
They're a little pricey, but they look beefy. So I don't think I'll break them as much as the flow ride. But they look like they change fucking quicker.
Yeah, no, they change super quick.
And that's what I'm about, dude. Like, I break shit, and I like to break shit and be able to change it. Dude, that's why I don't like fucking, like, monoplates.
Yeah.
Dude, because I, like, sometimes I go out with the intention of, like, okay, I'm for sure flying my quad, and I'm trying crazy shit until it just, they all just don't come home.
Yep.
You know? And if I can change an arm, that's going to keep me pushing that shit and, you know, getting that crazy fucking double tree gap shit.
Yeah, I mean,
dude, tree flying is my favorite. Like, I don't know, what's your favorite kind of flying? Yeah, that's your next question. What's your favorite kind of flying?
Diverse. Like, I want trees and buildings in the same spot. Like, I want trees, building, and open space. So that way, if I have to kind of get a little fucking, you know, collect myself, I can go back to, like, that open space. But also, if I want to try a new trick or something, I can do it open air. And then I can come out of it and I can go back through, like, a tree gap or something like that. But really, like, I mean, there's a lot of video that I can't put out because of the spots I fly in. Like, you can't do it. Me and Mira and Connor went to a spot. We were walking around and we couldn't do anything. I couldn't film because every time I'd fly into an area, there was like a, you know, like a do not trespass sign. But we were outside of that spot and it's kind of like, shady. Like, I'm not going to put it up. It's not worth it. But the flying is great. So I'm still having a fucking blast and everybody had a good time. So, I don't know. What about you? Like, what are your limitations on flying? Like,
so I love to fucking, like, destroy a nice cliff face or, you know, follow a nice ridge line down, fucking haul ass. But, dude, there's just something about, like, the drib fucking tree flying. That has been my, like, number one goal since I started flying. Like, just fly through the trees, like, drib and schizo and Johnny, dude. Just fucking, like, locked in. You see a line and you just fucking go for it, but it's not all smooth and jerky like steel, you know, just nice fucking smooth tree. Like, it's just, you're moving a fucking camera through the air. You know, that's what I do when I fly is I fucking push my GoPro through the air. That's all my quad is. That's why, like, a lot of people run their motor noise. I don't, because for me, it's not as much flying a fucking drone as it is pushing a fucking camera through the air so I can get those cool shots.
Yeah.
Also, you know, but yeah,
I just want to let people know,
like, mountains are dope, but
I can't reply. I can't post to my own
shit. To that tree spot that I fly at a lot next to the river and by the Mount Garfield place that the base jumpers came off, like Riverbend Park, that is like my all-time favorite park. Because the trees are just these big old fucking cottonwoods that have been growing forever. It's a disc golf course, so it's nice and green, and they keep the grass nice. But yeah, trees for sure.
Fuck yeah. Actually, I was replying to Josh Withrow, like, golf courses for the win, man. Like, they're just...
That's where I learned is a golf course.
Yeah, same here. Like, they're just... They're so fucking perfect, and you put the motor noise, well... Aaron is saying 25%. I bring it
I
down.
I get it. Like, I get I totally, like, I totally respect it. I do.
Dude,
it's just like the way I do things. Like, I'm more like trying to just like tell a story with video, you know. You guys know it's a fucking drone, you know.
Yep.
And I always bring motor noise in on wrecks because you gotta hear, like, that's a fucking quad hitting something, you know. That's not a camera hitting something.
Exactly. Well, it's funny too, because like before we were on the live stream, we were talking about, like, dude, the fucking golf course is open because all the golfers are gone. It's way too cold. Like, I flew, it was like 30 some odd degrees out. Like, it was below freezing. So it was like between 30 and 32 degrees. And I went out to rip and I was pissed because all the footage is just shit because I haven't tuned my quad. And it's a new build. I went out and I got to fly with like Canadian geese and I was just chilling with them. Dude, it was awesome fucking footage. For me, it was fucking amazing. And I couldn't fucking believe that, but...
Dude, honestly, like, at the end of the day, even if I come home with, like, ruined footage, I still have a fucking good time.
Oh, hell yeah.
Still what it's about. Dude, when I climbed that motherfucking palm tree, when I got stuck down at Brockahula...
You should have...
I got the fucking quad out of the tree, right? I plugged the SD card in my computer. I uploaded the one clip that was me going into the fucking tree.
Yeah.
Because I'm like, okay, I'll just upload it later. I just wanted to get that one clip and get that edit out real quick. Right? Yep. So I put the fucking SD card back in the GoPro, went out to fly, saw that I had minimal space, and I was like, yeah, I plugged it into my computer. Yeah, I uploaded it. So I just formatted it. Like, yeah, I had the footage. And I go home to fucking edit the, like, the flight of it, and nope, fucking gone. Just all that footage I climbed 50 feet in the air for was fucking gone.
Well, here's the thing. If do you go out flying with no recording? Like, do you go out to fly just to fly?
No. Every time I fly, I record. That's been something I've done since I started flying. I wouldn't fly if I couldn't record. Because in my thought process, I was like, fuck, if I'm going to break something and have to spend money, I at least want it to be on camera.
All right, how about this? What's the percentage of footage that you capture as opposed to how much you actually use in a video? Like, if you go to a spot and you have 100%.
Probably 5 to 20%, depending on the day and how much footage I capture.
What, that's how much you throw away or that's how much you
use? No, that's how much I put into the edit.
No shit.
Dude, I fly a fucking lot and I shoot a lot on my camera. A lot of it never sees the light of day.
Dude, that's funny.
Dude, I shoot so much fucking shit.
Dude, that's funny because I only have like, I think I have 5 packs. So, like, I'm going out and these are
your. I have like, I have fucking 40 batteries.
Okay, yeah.
I never, ever bring them all. Ever. I just, like, okay, those ones I flew yesterday, I'll fly these ones a day, and then I'll just fucking swap them back and forth.
Dude, mine are charged all 100% right now. Like, I'm ready to fucking go fly right now. And yeah, I've been flown for, like, 3 days. So it's terrible, because I'm just waiting for that opportunity, I guess, to go. But,
no, I there's a little bit of debate about, motor noise. I really, really think motor noise has its fucking place. The way I do my edits, I don't think so. But I see a lot of edits that don't have motor noise that probably should.
Like
certain long range edits, I think like surfing a fucking chute real tight down with a little bit of motor noise would be cool. So you could hear how hard that quad is working. Or like maybe like some track footage so you can hear the fucking throttle.
Yeah.
You know, that kind of shit. But
see, I like throwing it in because I'm twitchy as fuck. And it's just like 100% zero, 100% zero. Roll, flip, I'm upside down, doing something, and then back to 100% throttle. It's I don't know, like I'll put it in, but I'll put it in real fucking low behind the music. But I think
I do the same thing. I add motor noise back on crashes on every single one because you got to. It's showing that you're fucking taking your little thing that you're flying around that's looks like you're doing a really good job and you're not crashing at all. And then all of a sudden, oh shit, you can hear something else is fucking going on. And then destruction. I fucking love that.
All right. What do you look for in a new spot? Like if you're just, if you're sitting there,
if
you're
it's
like,
fucking empty.
Like, how do you find a new spot, and what do you look for?
So Grand Junction is kind of weird like that. We have, like, a set amount of spots that are in town, say, like, buildings or trees or structures or, like, just shit in town. Mm-hmm. And then we have, like, the mountains and Moab. That shit is endless. Hi, Zorro.
Did it just freeze everything?
No, you're good.
Dude, yeah, no, you're we're good. Yeah, we're not live. We just shut it off.
But yeah, I forgot what I was saying.
Dude, I forgot what I asked. Yeah.
Zorro's pretty face distracted me.
I'm just staring at his beautiful chin. I think he's frozen.
Get fucking gearhead. He's like, I wish guys like Johnny or Willie or Schizo would have had motor noise so you could figure out how they do the stuff they do. Their secret is they, whatever they're doing it a lot. They fly a lot. They might not post a lot. They just fly a lot.
Dude, I don't know if Zoro's trolling us and being really still or if he's out.
I think his picture froze.
Yeah, I think so.
Yeah.
Hey, Bert.
Hi, Zorro.
I should pin him and we could just talk.
Dude, I wish fucking Wombat was here so he could...
Hi, everybody. Oh, my name's Zorro.
Oh, hey, Zorro.
Hey, Zorro here.
Is that what you want? Huh?
Dude, but those three guys are fucking high up on the list. Johnny, Willie, and Schizo. Those dudes are fucking like madmen.
Dude, did you see that Johnny was flying with Will Smith, giving him a fucking ride-along?
Is that who it was? That video, there, that picture, I feel like, is old. I've seen that a while ago.
Yeah.
And I figured it was one of the top guys.
Yeah. Oh, man.
Yeah, stick time, I've said that from the start. Like, there's no substitute for stick time. Like... I fly the way I do because I've flown a lot, you know, and that's one thing that I think I have on Spoonie is just I've flown under the fucking goggles a lot more than him. Like, he does the same line, same moves and shit. I just might have that little bit of, like, knowing how to control the quad to get the smoothest fucking line, you know?
Yeah.
And that's fucking half of it. It's like, you know how to point your quad where you need it, and the other half is fucking throttle control. You know, with Duke, that's more than half, I would say, is using enough Duke, because throttle's everything. It's your fucking going forward, like, you know, it's your brakes, like, it's everything.
All right, so one more question, and you know why I'm asking you this. Rates. What do you have to say about rates?
Okay, so I started, I think I was trying to be Mr. Steel Jr. or something, but I think I started with some Mr. Steel rates because that's just kind of whose videos I really latched onto. Like, Sharpoo was really the one that, like, made me fall in love, but then Mr. Steel had more, like, the vlogginess, and so it was easier to kind of just, like, understand what he was talking about and kind of fucking learning as I go or whatever. But then it was just like, it was just seemed too much, you know? And so I dropped them, I think, to like just over 1,000. I think Mr. Steel's like 1,300 or something. Maybe more, maybe less. I don't remember. But now, like, at that point, I was like, okay, I'll drop it to 1,000 and think that's good. And I was there for a long time. But then my buddy down in the town below me, he's a badass racer, dude. He's like fucking definitely top 20 in the U.S. right now. Mm-hmm. FPV Davis. And he's like fucking 16.
No shit.
Yeah, but I had a long conversation with him about rates and shit. And, dude, that motherfucker flies at like 667 degrees per second. And when he told me that, I'm like, that kind of seems slow. And he was telling me, he's like, Well, just think about it. Do you really want to flip two times in a second? And I'm like, I guess you don't need to if you're not trying to do Mr. Steel stuff, you know? Mm. And so he's like, dude, just drop this shit. And my FPV freestyle footage instantly became like 100% more juicy, like all of it. Even if I flew shitty, like it just looked way fucking better. Drop your race. Everybody needs to drop the race. Dude, Ben flies at like, isn't he flying at like 420 right now?
No, I think he's flying at 600. He told me to, like, I talked to you and him about rates, like, different chat. And he was like, dude, put him down to 600, go out and rip. You'll fucking love it. And then you were like, dude, put
Josh,
him down to...
Josh Withrow, he knows what's up. Fucking 620 degrees per second.
Dude, and it made...
I don't run any expo either. I just don't like expo. What's up, Frosty?
What's up, Zorro? What do you...
Yeah, how you doing, Zorro? We didn't get to say really hi to you last time you boned out or your computer glitched out or something.
It was everything. Oh, I had to edit, too. I had to edit my stupid video.
Oh, that's why you froze.
Well, that was part of it. Oh, you mean just now?
Just a minute ago. Yeah, it was funny, dude. It froze on your face, and it honestly probably took us a good minute or two before we were like, wait a second. Okay, hold on a second.
Really?
Yeah. Dude, where'd you get that dope fucking light behind you?
The
dude?
Sign,
that's
dude. The sign is
awesome.
Legit.
Oh, the sign. Hold on. The light. Oh. It's my boy Boobs FPV did it.
Oh, Boobs did that? No shit.
Boob did it with his hands. Right here. And he made this metal one. Well,
I really like that guy.
Oh, yeah, well, I like him.
He is cool. He's a fucking good dude.
He's great, and he's really funny. And
he makes a quality sign.
Dude, that's a quality sign for sure. Well, so what does he do? Like, does he make sign shop? Well, like, does he do other shit too?
No, I think it's a family business that he's doing.
Oh, that's cool.
Look at my... Oh, now you can see the sign. Well, I saw the sign. Come on, everybody. Everybody in the chat.
But yeah. I opened up the doors, I saw the sign.
Dude, I forget what song. We sang a song at the fucking bar earlier, and it was like one of the American songs. I can't remember what the fuck it was. But I was the only person out of like 40 people that knew the words. And I'm like, I'm going home.
Was it Bruce Springsteen song?
No, I don't remember what the fucking song was. Cause dude, we had hibachi and somebody was like vaping and blowing the fucking, like the fucking dab clouds, like right in the fucking dude's,
dude,
like,
Enoch's
right
on his way
face.
Home say hi to Enoch.
Hi,
hey,
Enoch.
In a picture.
Hey, buddy.
Alright. Okay. Sick.
I hope he gets it.
Nailed it.
Well, don't let me derail you from your very interesting race.
Dude, no, we were literally just like getting drunk asking each other questions.
Yeah,
I know.
Well,
because, I watched it all the way up to here.
Because we couldn't think of anything else to do. It was just too.
Oh, you talking quads?
Yeah.
It came down to that,
yeah.
Huh?
So yeah, it came. Sometimes it comes down to actually talking about the quad. Shit we do.
Yeah,
the shit show came down to actually talking about FPV stuff. Dude, what? Okay, here's a question.
But
Zorro.
We haven't said this one time, and it's on the fucking thumbnail. FPV is not dead.
No.
Motherfuckers. Why? I don't even. Where did that even come from? I don't fucking get it.
So I watched this magician guy on YouTube. His name, dude, he's dope. His name is Chris Ramsey. You guys should check him out. He's from Canada. But he's really dope. Like, his videos are dope. And he just made a video called Is Magic Dead? And I think every hobby just has a thing where it's like, oh my god, nobody else is doing it. Is it dead?
Yeah.
No, it's not dead. Magic's not dead. FPV's not dead.
Nothing. Like, it's everything just grows, you know?
Well, honestly, if people think that FPV is dead, now is the time to go out and have fucking fun. Because let it fucking die. And the people that
it
actually
will never die, dude. It's just gonna get bigger. Like it's gay. It will probably get shittier, honestly. But I don't care because I want it to get out to people. This is fucking cool, and I want to share this with everybody. Mm-hmm. You know.
But you're.
We need to make it a religion. Sorry.
Exactly, dude.
Oh no, we definitely should.
Exactly.
We can make it a religion where we go out and you have to tell other people about FPV and how it saved your life.
Dude, straight up.
And if you're not, you're going to hell.
Yes.
Just like regular church.
so I should... Dude, I thought that was a piece of chocolate. What the fuck are you... Here's my first question for Zorro.
Look at my vape, y'all. I'm toking on nicotine salts now because I'm so awesome. Nicotine salts are the shit. It's like meth of, like, vaping. It's like little crystals and shit.
You got a little teener in your pocket?
Yeah, a little bump for the morning. This thing, dude, every hit feels like a cigarette. Like the satisfaction. Wow. Yeah.
That's cool. Fun.
It's funny because Hillary's using the Juul and she watched one of your videos and she was like, holy shit, this thing is helping me quit smoking. And I'm like, oh, try the dripper. And I put this in with like a ton of fucking, you know, a ton of juice and a ton of nicotine. She's like, no, not the same. And she walked away like hitting that thing.
It's not, but you don't get clouds, which I don't give a shit about.
It's about the urge, you know. Like,
yeah, it's like I want to feel satisfied. I need nicotine in my.
But yeah, fuck the dude. The cloud is the worst fucking part about a vape, dude.
Yeah, dude, I God. In like restaurants and everything, nobody can even.
Yeah. Dude, that's like legitimately what. Like, I didn't even buy my vape. My ex got it for me for Christmas. Like, I never would have bought one. I just always thought they were fucking douchey as fuck. Like, anytime you see somebody like blowing a big old cloud, you're like, look at that fucking douchebag right there. Like,
did you just think that when I was blowing that cloud?
No, I used to. I absolutely used to.
Oh, I thought you meant like right now. You were like, whoa, look at that douchebag.
I got a fucking Zorro, vape. I hit that thing. You know? And Zorro. Like, when I'm inside the grow and shit, I'll fucking hit my vape.
What a douchebag with Hello Kitty.
That's just what I like. Dude, I was. We're all ignorant at points. Don't put yourself on a higher pedestal than me, Craig.
We're on equal pedestals here.
Yes.
No, it's cool. No, I said Hello Kitty. I'm
yeah, no, but now, fine. No, like, I just think it's funny, dude. Vapes are fucking funny, dude.
Gravy, you want to say something? Is that what you were doing?
No, I was just blocking the
laundry. I saw you flailing your arms.
No, I was blocking the laundry. Because
I don't know what to do with my hands.
With that.
Oh, shit, I don't, you guys.
Oh, dude, that's like dab business. No, I'm up. I'm good.
Oh, we should smoke weed. I don't have any alcohol.
We should smoke weed.
You guys pass me a beer maybe or something? Or...
There's some weed right.
I got plenty of weed.
You see those jars?
That I do. Yes. Dude, so last weekend, that RC shop that I did that logo for, and we started the Anything RC, they had this fucking remote control get-together thing up in Ukiah, and it was super fun. I miss RC trucks. And the dude gave my daughter a free fucking RC car, and I was like, hell no. So I kept it. So here you go. I was like, thanks. She'll play with it. And I was like, I'm like, don't you fucking touch that thing.
Sick. It's cool because you know
she's not going to watch this.
I think it might be 4 or 6. The shit that we were driving out there and the kind that I have here is like 8S, dude. Fucking 4S.
Yeah, dude. 4S's. Those 8S fucking rigs will fucking make the tires look like fucking pizza cutters and shit, dude.
Yeah.
One of the dudes was... going through this field, and he was going hell fast, and a rock hit his tire, and it split it, like it cut it in half. It was like exploded and shit. But RC cars are fucking awesome. They're just and the battery lasts for a lot longer.
Dude. Yeah, for sure, dude. You can fly those fuckers forever, or ride those fuckers forever.
Dude, yeah, I fly my RC trucks
Dude, my homie had his RC rock crawlers out. At this camp out we did, and dude, those things are fucking badass. They go super slow, so you don't. It's not like you like smash them into a fucking curb and destroy it. You know, it'll just roll down a hill. But dude, those things are badass. Like he let me play with one. We put a whoop. We taped a whoop to the hood. Dude, we were doing FPV rock crawling. It was fucking cool, dude.
I want a tiny rock crawler so I can put it on my wiener and I can see. No, I'm serious.
That's how I pee now, is I just put the camera on my dick, and I'm just like, lined up for battle.
Yeah. His crawler goes for 4 hours. Dude, that's long.
What? Dude.
4 hours?
Yeah.
Dude, Aaron's got some fucking dope crawlers. It's because you're just fucking
cruising around.
Yeah. No, dude, he goes out like looking for fucking spots to fly with his Growler.
Yeah.
Have you seen him flying the waterfalls and shit like that?
Yeah.
Like, if I had to buy something other than like quad RC shit, it would be a rock crawler for sure.
Oh, fuck yeah. Mm-hmm. All right, Zoro, question from the chat, because now you're in on this. What are your rates?
What are my rates?
Yeah.
Like $100 an hour. No,
that's what she said.
I'm not. No, thank you very much.
Yeah, dude, that's good. That's not good.
So this is what I did. I asked early on. I asked Bot for his rates, and then I put him in.
I was
like, oh my god, I'm driving like super. Like, it was nice and like slow, and I got like a little smoother from that. And then at the end of stick shit, it was like, wah! It was going crazy. So then I tried Drew's rates, and that shit was like really weird. It didn't act normally.
Then, I bet. Like, I bet his rates were super fucking weird, dude. He looks like he flies. You know, it's almost like it's like a lag behind. Like, he just knows like a second before, and he's just always like a second. I don't know.
Yeah, and it's really responsive in a weird way. Like, it's responsive, and like the yaw is really responsive. Anyways, but then Overflow fucking shared his, and I think they're public too. He posted them up, dude, and those are like exactly like the shit
what you want.
Yeah, although I don't fly like Overflow. If I flew like Overflow, I would fly like.
So you would have 10,000 subs if you flew like him.
At least.
For sure.
I would have like 4,000 subs.
So no, so that is what you want? Huh?
Dude, Overflow's a beast. If you guys don't know him, check him out.
He's fucking amazing. He's my favorite pilot in the world.
Dude, him and Vic Landing, just like. They have like that just snappy fucking. They do Mr. Steel style better than Mr. Steel.
Yeah, Mr. Steel like does like too much.
Exactly. You know what I mean?
He's fucking amazing. Like
He is, but it's just it's hard to watch and follow, you know.
Sometimes I'm like
fucking fly, you're like, all right, dude.
He's kinda toned it down. There was a period a few months ago when he was going crazy. I couldn't even watch it.
It was literally just like
But now he's like, he flew. Every time I watch him, I'm like, fuck, dude, he's so good. Damn him.
Dude, any video, like, even if I do end up being like, fuck, like, okay, like, he's going too fast, I still am like, God, this dude is a beast, you know?
He has control, like, really well.
Yeah.
Yeah. Dude. And our arms are hurting real bad because we've been swinging on Mr. Steel's nuts so hard. And our arms are killing us because.
Well, it's funny. Everybody got in.
Because he was really like the one that I started watching him, his videos, like religiously. Like the one, like, I was like, oh shit, like, when's Mr. Steel put out a new video? You know, like, he was the first one where I was like that. And that, you know, like, now I'm like that with a lot of other, you know, pilots. And I think that's fucking cool. But he was like really like the first fucking one, you know. Dude, like the fucking shit when they went to Chernobyl and he fucking got his shit stuck in the fucking dude and they had that dude climb up. Like, that shit is so entertaining.
Yep.
You know, like, that's what made Rotor Riot, dude.
If you could fly, like, here's a question for you, fucking guys. If you could fly like anyone, like exactly like them, like their skills, who would you fly with? Like,
it has to be just one?
Yeah, what, you want a combination of people?
Oh, yeah.
Well, no, you can't have it. You can only have one.
I got one.
Okay.
Don't say me, you guys. I'll be really embarrassed today.
Fuck. I'll say LeDrib.
Yeah. For sure.
Yeah.
How about
something
you?
Something about it.
Schizo.
Schizo is number two. And then it goes Johnny FPV.
Yeah.
Those three?
I don't know. Schizo has that slow lock shit. And then he has the freak the fuck out shit. And that's what makes me not want to fly low rates. Like, I've been flying, like, you and Ben told me, try low rates, and I'm fucking hooked on, like, the 600s. But, man, like, it's so fucking good. But Schizo, he can throw, like, 11,000 fucking rolls and then be, like, nice and mellow. And he only moves the stick, like, maybe, like, a hundredth of a fucking inch. and he just knows where
it's
going
to
go.
It's hard to have, like, a style. You know what I mean? It's hard to actually, like, have a style where, like, if I watch, like, Overflow or, like, Schizo or some people, I can totally tell the...
But, dude, like, that's what I'm trying... That's honestly my been my goal for a while is, like, just find my own style. The way, you know, I do a lot of, like little snappy reverse things that I don't see many pilots doing. MacTac, I see MacTac doing that shit, and that's what's up. But so I'm very, like, reversey and, like, just, like, you know, like, fucking floatiness, and then, like, I don't know, like...
I like to be real uneven when I fly, so, like, that's...
So when I fly, I try to, like, do, like, the Schizo Johnny Drip. Like, that's, like, my mind. It's just, like, find a fucking line and do some crazy, like, super close to the tree shit, but still have... See, Drip is never, ever snappy. It's always smooth, you know? But I still like the snappiness. I do. At certain points, like, I really like the Johnny, like, little, like, you know, around the trees and fucking... That shit is really fucking cool, but...
Schizo does some, like, unexpected shit. Like,
he does. Schizo is always, like, a mind fuck.
I wasn't really watching him until, like, I met him. Because I, like, I've seen some stuff, and I'm like, okay, it's, like, really nice. You know what I mean? It's, like, really good. But then I watched it, and I was like, dude, it's, like, he fucks with, like, time and shit. Or he does, like, shit that you don't even expect to see, you know? Like, and, you know, it's, like, easy in your head. You're like, yeah, I'm going to go and do that. And then every time I go to fly, I do the same fucking shit over and over. And I have
It's like
that's what I'm saying. Sometimes you got to go out and you got to be like, okay, I'm going to do this, and you have to have something in mind that you've never done before that you're probably going to break some shit on, but at least you will get the experience under the sticks on your quad. It's not a fucking sim, you know. Like, you've done it in the sim, you're like, okay, now I'm going to do this.
Oh, and here's the other thing I've been thinking about. I don't. Did we talk about this? if I said this last time? Fucking let me know. But, like, there's two things in the way that we fly, right? There's, like, what the quad is doing, like, how a skateboard does shit, and then, like, what the video looks like, which is a whole other thing.
Yes.
So you could get, like, a cool video by, like, maybe the quad's not doing impressive shit. But, like, I feel like we fly, like, we think, like, what can the quad do that's cool? But then sometimes the video doesn't, like, come out to be, like, it's too much.
Of course. Right?
So it's, like, it's kind of weird how there's, like, two things happening, where it's, like, what you're doing versus, like, what the video is.
What, well, like, the end result, dude, like, because your experience is way different than the end result of video, you know, and that's also, like, a big thing when I look when I'm doing an edit. I try to, like, capture that emotion that I felt when I was under the sticks, you know, like, the fucking, even if sometimes I might go a little hard on the light or the color, that's just kind of what I was feeling at that point, you know, it's just like, that's the emotion you're trying to, like, grasp out of the... Dude, it's fucking art, you know. I look at
no right and wrong.
Yeah,
you know, dude. It's all perception. Like, you dig it, you know. Even if you're real shitty, that's your.
But thing. I definitely have been working on toning it down, dude. Schizo commented on one of my videos a long time ago, and he said something about my color grading, about, like, how a lot of people are overdoing it nowadays. And I really was like, fuck. Okay, I better tone it back. If he's saying something, I'll listen.
Oh shit! It's a Maddie storm, bud. Bye.
Enoch, like what you were talking about,
it's really important, like, that everybody has their own fucking thing. Yeah, that's really important because
Maddie Storm,
fuck. Hey Matt, there's, like, a lag on your mic.
Is there really? So,
like, when you talk, it takes a second for it to come in, and then it fades out.
Yeah, so might be.
What a dick.
Hold on, Enoch. My dick is fading out.
Faded.
Can you play his dick out, please?
This boy's dick is faded glory.
You
gotta repaint it every year. You gotta repaint that.
Oh, shit.
That's a phone. Okay. So
I gotta piss. I'll be right back.
Alright, he's gone. Alright.
We're not live, right?
No, definitely not.
No, how's your diarrhea? It's good?
Little Hershey squirts.
Little something. Hey, Matt, it's just you and I. Finally.
Oh, fuck.
Oh, he's back. Never mind. What'd you bring, oranges?
Nope, even better.
Is that nicotine salt?
Fire Jerry Kush and Sukus.
Oh, I found out today that... Hey, so your dispensaries deliver to me.
What the fuck?
I found that out tonight. It's a Christmas miracle. I found that out at the Christmas party.
Hey, it's a Christmas miracle.
It is, bud. Cheers.
God bless us, everyone.
Hey, look it. Mr. Steele's rubbing Vortex's tree there.
Ah, Vortex's tree. Oh, yeah.
All right, so Enoch, what do you run for rates? Real quick. Rapid what? Fire. What do you run for rates, bud?
Yeah, don't tell the... fake.
Like 11, 950.
Okay.
On an acro.
What do you run on a Horizon mode?
Enoch, fucking, I was in the Discord chat today and I was like just talking to somebody and somebody that just randomly posts a fucking link to one of your videos.
Bah.
I was like, oh shit, that's my boy.
By accident.
All right. So I have a question. Me and Chris were talking about this earlier. How do you go about your edit? And actually, Enoch can jump in here too, because all three of you guys edit way fucking different. So, you guys are all like murdering the fucking editing game, but how do you go about like your entire edit, I guess? Chris, you can start.
You spit in your hand. That's step one.
You murder it.
All right, done.
Gotta have the spit on your hand.
Ew. Is that really spit?
Yeah.
Oh my god, I hate spit so much. That's fucking disgusting, dude.
Dude, I'm just segueing so I can piss.
You know what this is? This is the real Christmas miracle, boys.
Yeah, the cinnamon. Cinnamon shine.
Cinnamon shine.
Dude,
gravy. Step one is fucking go out and rip.
Dude, I'm not going outside to rip right now. I'm going to get the moonshine.
No. Well, you asked how to make a good edit.
No. I asked.
Is strong with this one.
I Holy asked, shit. Like, I asked, because all
you
three
know how
you
to
guys...
do that. You know how to go out and rip.
Okay, so all three of you guys have a different editing style, but you're all killing edits. So, Chris, you start with your formula, and then, I guess, Zoro and Enoch, because he's drinking coffee.
Let me just ask Chris, how much DMT is in your formula, bud?
Seven.
That trippy shit was hella trippy.
Dude, the shit that was just... God, everybody's done the fucking kaleidoscope shit. That was just me getting some shit together for a show.
It's pretty dope.
But
it was pretty dope.
The DMT is a whole other level. That's some real shit.
I wanna try.
When you think you've done some shit and then you did DMT, you're like, okay, everything I've done up to this point, that's not shit at
all.
Have
you done it?
Yeah, dude. It is fucking gnarly.
Yeah, I want to try it so fucking bad.
Dude, okay, so you know how, like, when you're tripping, you still know you took something and you're tripping. Dude, yeah. DMT is like, you hit it, and you don't even know that you hit something to make you feel like the way you're feeling. You just don't even know what the fuck is going on. Like, you cannot put it together. You're like, and your first instinct is like, like, you want to fight it. But
you go death, you want to, like,
You do not want to like give in, and that's the hardest part. Is like I didn't blast off the first few times I did it because I like was like trying to hold on, but you will not like trip if you do that.
If you don't blast off, is it just like colorful?
It's not like colorful. It's more like you know, like at the afterwards of like mushrooms or some shit. Mm-hmm. You know, it's a very like mind bakey, and you're just kind of like almost feels kind of like a weed high. Mm-hmm. You know.
The only thing that freaks me out is this chick was telling the story, because I've watched every fucking DMT trip.
Dude, try it, bro. You can handle it, dude.
Oh yeah, no, I know. Again, I don't have any. That's the thing.
That's the hard part. That's the fucking hard part.
But I watched this one chick, and she did it, and she was like trying to come out of it, and like she didn't come out of it, and she had to go to the hospital, and she like got kind of stuck in that for like a day or so.
Okay, well, I'll tell you this other story. Well. My buddy wanted to do it in like a dark fucking quiet room. We wanted to try and recreate like a sensory deprivation chamber.
Right.
So dude, we packed up a big old fucking bong rip from him, and dude, we went in my grow room and we turned off all the fucking lights, all the fans, so it was super fucking dark. Dude, but he wanted me in there with him just in case, you know.
Yeah, yeah. Yeah.
So I went in there, dude, and like the light, I couldn't see him at all, but he took this hit and I could feel his trip. It was fucking weird. Like, I was sober, but I could feel his energy And there was a point. There was a point where, like, I could hear him breathing really fast, and I'd like put my hand on his chest, and I was like, "Yo, you're here on Earth. Like, this is Chris. Mm-hmm. Like, I'm here with you."
That's good.
And his fucking breathing like slowed down.
Mm-hmm.
But dude, like, if don't do that your first time, for sure not. Like, do it in your room, maybe with like one or two homies that you trust. Like, whoever you do with, you gotta fucking trust, because shit gets weird.
Yeah.
And if something happens, it's weird as fuck.
Right. Oh no, I've done like,
cool with it, you know.
Back in the day, I took to my first rave, dude. I took like, I don't know how many sugar cubes and how many tabs. And I had, like, I'm still never the same after that. Like, I had, like, a voice, like, explaining shit to me. Like,
there was,
like, a whirlwind of, like, people going through. Like, this auditory voice was, like, telling me what tribal means and, like, all this different shit. I didn't even, like, ask or anything. It was a trip, dude.
LSD is my favorite. Like, I love mushrooms, but something about LSD. Dude, my fucking name is Westside. Like, that's why it's fucking PSY. And,
oh, really?
Yeah, dude. Like, I love this.
Trip together, man.
Yeah, dude. I love the psychedelics, bro.
Look, maybe... Gravy's like, what the fuck happened to my
dude,
show?
I just walked back into this. And it's like, why is everybody microdosing at the fucking tea party? And why is
it's
everybody
the only way to get the good edits nowadays.
Yeah, that's, you asked how you wanted the good edits. This is how. Enough, dude.
There's the answer. Oh, great. Shit.
Cheers, motherfuckers.
Cheers. Man.
Yeah, that's
how empty. Was your how was your night, you know?
We found, we started the gig pretty good, finding a used condom on the stage.
Yes. That's how you know your night is just going to be a fucking
blast. It was on point. And then we got done with the gig and a bunch of rappers showed up to rap. And I was like, dude, it's like 5 minutes past the end of the gig. And then I said, fuck it. Give them a half hour. I mean, I had a sound system set up, and they drove from, like, you know, a city nearby to try to rap at this free concert. So they just made it late because they were probably smoking weed. And I was like, all right, fine. Because I knew you guys had the shit show.
Hell yeah, yeah. Dude, it literally started out with me and Gravy, like, trying to talk. We're like sitting here like, fuck.
No,
we're
honestly,
both like, Gravy's like coming off his party, so he's like still like buzzing up and down. I'm like sober as shit when I started.
Now you're not.
Yo, I'm gonna be so fucked. This stuff is no joke. Like,
dude,
I can feel my.
I want to see you take a drink.
Bro, I've been sipping it.
I want to see, but I haven't seen it. I haven't seen it.
All right. I'm telling you though.
Hold on.
I'm going to black out and wake up in my neighbor's refrigerator naked.
Hold on. Wait. We got to wait for Zoro. He's got a Pepsi One. All right. Cheers to Enoch with what he's drinking on.
Cheers, Enoch.
Is that a Pepsi One? Is that what you want?
It's a regular diet Pepsi.
Oh.
Pepsi One? Is all that right. A thing?
I'm coming, chat.
Primitive says $10. Zora's tripping right now. Does he win $10 or not?
What's funny is today's probably the only day that I'm not tripping.
Oh, Primitive, you lost. You owe Zora $10.
Oh, it's Primitive. FPV, my boy.
Ian.
Dude, Primitive's dope. I like Primitive.
Oh, wait. Actually,
yeah, Ian is the man. I love Ian.
Yeah.
He's the best.
He also owes you $10.
Yeah, he does. Chad, fucking. Talk because shit to him, dude.
Because you're not tripping.
Anytime I see him, I'm gonna ask him now if he's paid you $10.
Yeah, me too.
Dude, we should all like pester him until $10 is paid.
We should all just say somebody owes us $10 right now and use the power of the UFDA crew to get $10 somehow.
Let's all say that Mike from UFDA owes us $10.
Yeah. That guy.
I want my $2.
Dude, what? So what, next week we're good to go or what? On the channel?
No, 2 weeks.
2 weeks.
2 weeks.
We're almost there, boys. Oh, we almost did it.
We're going to be back.
Yeah, hey. So next week, we're just ending my entire fucking channel. It's going to be dicks and butts and boobs.
Damn.
And we're crashing the whole fucking thing. Fuck 3 months.
It's always dicks and butts and boobs.
Well, I mean, I posted anyway, so...
What? Oh, you put up a new video that has dicks and butts and boobs?
About to.
Yo, actually, everybody for the next like week should just call all FPV videos dicks, butts, boobs. You got to use a comma between the words.
You know what the funny thing is? I can't even fucking type.
Later, MacTac. Hey, if you guys don't know who MacTac is, go check this fucking guy out.
Hell yeah.
Fucking ripper. He's bouncing. He's from BC. Fucking.
Zarripas.
Hell yeah.
Don't tell us what to do.
Me and him are racing to 1,000. Dude, Zorro, fuck up. Shut the fuck up and go sub MacTac right now. Dude.
Zorro. Sub to who?
Fuck up.
Fuck up.
Fuck up, dude.
Dude, I've corrupted Chris Teal somehow. Look at his shirt. I corrupted that guy.
Hey, yeah, you guys like my shirt I got on Black Friday?
Yeah, does it make it for men?
I just want to let everybody know I can't even comment in the fucking comment section of my own live stream, so I apologize. I've been typing, but I keep getting a fucking error. I'll just say it now. Hi. Hi, boys. Don't wait.
Hey, Garvey.
Yeah, hey Garvey.
Hashtag DMT life.
Yeah,
dude, I don't
for real. Okay, so like, I don't think everybody should try LSD or mushrooms. I think everybody should try DMT. Well, it will legitimately like straighten you the fuck out and be like, okay, this is who you are. Like straight up, it will answer a lot of your own questions that you've asked yourself for a long fucking time.
Is like, it like the torsos?
You still, but I thought you found it.
That's what it will answer.
I thought you found it.
I did, but then I forgot.
You need more DMT.
And then they go,
yo, if you ask the DMT aliens where the clitoris is, they might tell you.
They'll show you, I'm sure. Did you see any cool jesters?
Any aliens on your journey?
Yeah, did you see any aliens or jesters, Chris Teal?
Yeah, the cyborg jesters.
It's not like that. Like,
oh, come on,
that's not what Joe Rogan said.
Rojogan? Have you guys seen
that motherfucker does it in sensory deprivation tanks? That motherfucker crazy.
That's fucked.
He's crazy, dude. No, he's fucking crazy.
Dude, I do
deprivation tanks.
I'll do that shit not on DMT. I'll do it on acid or mushrooms or some shit. But well, not on DMT.
Like, that's stupid.
It's fucking crazy. Like, I remember, like, hitting it the very, very first time I did it and I blasted off. I remember, like, going down these stairs and it felt like a fucking game show. Like, I had to, like, get down these fucking stairs all, like, but I had to do it, like, very precise, or like I would lose. You know? And like,
that's awesome.
And I like walked by my buddy's dog. It was a German Shepherd, and it was like a nice like I knew this dog, you know. And it was like at first it was like super friendly, and then like my mind just transformed it into this big old fucking like scary wolf. And I like,
oh no, you can go that way too.
Oh yeah, absolutely, dude. And I walked into the bathroom and I like looked at myself in the mirror, and dude, the mirror just started fucking like. It literally started like splitting and just, and then I had to like close my eyes for a second and I like took a breath and it like, it's weird. It'll like come in and out for like 5 minutes, dude. Like the very, like for the first minute, you're just fucking there. And then you just like slowly bounce back and forth. It's like bungee jumping, dude. Like you fucking, whoom, you know, and you're like bouncing there for a second and then you come back, you know. Like ayahuasca's like a fucking roller coaster. You're slowly going up.
You've done ayahuasca, you?
No, I've never done that.
Oh, okay.
I got buddies that have done that, and I don't even hang out with them because they're too weird.
That seems like hardcore. I don't like throwing up.
Yeah, me either.
That's hours. DMT, 5 fucking minutes. Seems like 3 fucking hours.
Dude, DMT is like the shortest high you can get, but it's the fucking best.
They used to call it the businessman's lunch break because they could do it in 5 minutes.
Yeah, people do it like in vape pens, like on the go. Yeah.
Dude, I had a buddy that would inject it.
Dude, there's no downtime.
That dude is fucking not with us anymore because of a heroin addiction. That dude was crazy as fuck. Anytime I would go over to his house, like I never saw him inject the fucking DMT, but anytime I would go over to his house, he'd literally be like smoking this fucking meth pipe with DMT in it, and he would like sit down in his chair and like have a conversation with me and hit it, go away for like 2 minutes and then come back and like try to conversate with me again. And it was a weird dude. That dude, I got a badass fucking laser work. Do you know, like equipment for big concerts and shit? Have you ever heard of Laser World Lasers?
I think so.
But they're based out of like Germany. They're like the super fucking expensive laser producer. And he had this badass laser. Anytime I would go over to his house, I was like, yo, dude, like, let me fucking get that. He's like, no fucking way, dude. I paid like $3,000 for this. Damn. I was like, ah, fuck. Like, I ain't paying $3,000 for it.
Right?
Dude, one day he was hard up for some heroin and he fucking hit me up. He's like, yo, dude, if you got $100, you can have it.
What?
Dude, so I have this badass laser, dude, that I take to shows and it always fucking gets fucking kicks. Everybody's always like, you, where'd you get that? Bro. From somebody's bad drug habit is where I got it.
Jeez, Murphy.
Ugh. I've never seen you this fired up about FPV, by the way. Just saying. You know what I'm saying?
I started drinking and I started. I think it was you. You were like, okay, now is this a drinking game? And as soon as I read that, I was like, okay, now I gotta drink. Look, I had to make it. We had to make it interesting because it was boring as fuck for the first 20 minutes.
We need an FPV, a safe, obviously. FPV drinking game.
Yeah, dude, for sure.
We need that.
Like, wait, while you're flying?
Hold on.
Yeah.
No.
Yeah. Hell yeah, dude. That's not rotor riot friendly, but
I don't give a fuck about that. It's like, what we gotta do is like
drink in your mouth. That's.
Didn't they do that? Who did that? Who took shots and tried to fucking rip around the warehouse?
Oh, rotor riot did that.
Yeah, dude.
It was Stingy. It was Stingy, Steel, and Tommy.
No, but I'm saying we should play skate. Except you gotta drink like hard liquor shots every time you fuck up.
You gotta take a shot of DMT every time.
Dude, it's perfect because it lasts as long as an entire fucking 4-cell. All
right, Brian Kirby says fly, so we gotta drink those.
Oh, goddamn.
That's not how that works. We gotta say fly. It's whoever's on the show says fly. I still think the Carolina Reaper challenge while you're flying would be fucking dope.
I still got to do the gummy bear challenge. I forgot who told me I got to do that, but I got to eat gummy bears off my radio while I'm flying.
You got to eat off your radio?
Yeah, while I'm flying. Like.
Yo. And then do you hide a piece of poop on there?
Wasn't there a question earlier
how close I got to eating shit, literally?
Yo, everybody's got to spread that link.
Spread that link like butter. That was APOC asking how close you've actually gotten to literally eating shit. Or wait, was that Zoro? No, that was Zoro. Zoro, so ask the question.
How close have you ever gotten to actually eating shit? Like literally.
End zone.
Every single time you buy tomato sauce, there's probably inside that tomato sauce. It's like 1% fecal matter. You have to be
wins.
And just
the,
be okay.
The shroom challenge. I would do that.
Dude, yeah. I'm down for the fucking beer funnel challenge.
Shrooms probably are 1% poop as well.
Probably more than one.
Yeah,
probably
way more than one.
Let me just say,
that's how close I've gotten to eating shit. Everybody here
has a toothbrush in the bathroom, right?
Yes.
Yeah, fecal bacteria is on that toothbrush. You're fucked.
I've Q-tips.
You're,
like,
you're banging your mouth with poop.
No, I do.
Banging my mouth with it.
my mouth has never been banged. What are you talking about?
That was some violent banging you do there. What did you
do? Oh, God.
Dude. Cinnamon.
Yeah. So you got four pilots. Everybody eats a quarter of mushrooms. Yep. First person who puts their radio down.
A quarter of mushrooms. Yeah. Fuck off.
Yeah, dude.
How about
if we're gonna do it, why do we?
All right,
fucking Terrence McKenna over here.
Is it legal to like tape your radio to your chest?
Yeah, why not?
It's no neck, no transmitter strap either. And I fly with a transmitter strap.
Oh, so you have to hold it.
Yeah.
Holy shit.
All right, or you strap a flashlight at the bottom of your radio. Yeah. And whoever busts the first... No, I'm just kidding.
Actually, that could definitely work. Like, if you just made a 3D printed mount and you took a crossfire out of the back of your transmitter and it was just a flashlight and you were like, okay, I can fly like this, and how long can you fly on DMT? Or PCP.
All right, listen. I want to put up a person on DMT flying versus a person getting head.
Person getting head would work. I'm telling you, DMT, you can't see. Like, it's you go fucking blind for a minute.
Damn.
But that minute is not a minute. That's the thing with DMT is it fucks with your time.
It totally does.
Yeah, DMT is only like a 2 or 3 minute trip unless you take a fuck ton. So why don't we come to an agreement? We can do like the blowjob challenge and we can fly.
The blowjob challenge.
How are we gonna prove this? We can't put that on.
Exactly. Wait, it's like proving you fucked somebody while you're driving. Like, you could tell somebody you did it, but
I've seen a picture of a dude getting ahead while he's flying FPV.
I mean,
at a Facebook group.
That's what kind of shit you're into, huh, Zoro?
Wait,
I didn't take the picture, I wasn't the person in the picture.
Wait, who like, just said I, that they I fucked actually, the dude while they were flying?
Porn, and it's like, it's porn of, it's like people doing acro around people banging. That's it. It's like, if the camera's not moving 60 miles an hour, I can't get off.
I would love to see a fucking misfire where, well, not that kind of misfire. Crashing into like a butt. Oh no!
You seen that Bam Margera video?
Dude, where they shoot the fucking dildo at his ass?
Yo, Bam Margera got a dildo, put it on a fucking DJI Phantom,
yes,
and flew it full speed at this girl's butt on a fucking golf cart.
I didn't know they did that, but dude, there's another video fucking that's like a legitimate porn video where they use like some phantom and they have a dildo strapped to it and they fucking penetrate this bitch.
Damn.
I've seen that one. And it's totally fake too.
Yeah.
Oh yeah.
Somebody's like holding
it. Right. Yeah, someone's got like sticks on it and they green screen the sticks out.
It's like no DJI. No DJI pilot has that kind of skill.
Maybe there's seriously something wrong with your mic.
Yeah,
you fade out to nothing, and then you come back.
Yeah,
We're coming up on 2 hours, so we're probably gonna kill it soon, anyways. So
I blame the fucking evil empire.
Yeah,
they're stopping your microphone from working,
dude. I blame the French. They're like the yellow vests are taking down my mic.
Yellow vests are taking down everything.
Yeah, but also cheers to them for not being cunts.
Dude, listen, if people are going to fuck you over, you should just fuck them up.
Dude, Canada's doing the same fucking thing. It's fucked.
Listen, when they do a gas tax, maybe people use less gas, but guess what actually happens? Everybody who needs to drive every day to work gets fucking stabbed in the fucking wall.
Enoch.
Like, of course they're going to get pissed.
Enoch, what are your GoPro settings?
My GoPro settings are, I think, whatever they're set to.
All right, auto, right on. Zoro, what are yours set to?
Hey, everybody, I want to see this man.
60 frames a second.
Just look at him. Look at him.
Oh, my God. What kind of meat is that?
I don't know.
He has a tail. What's up with that shit?
Is it pork or is it beef? Everybody in chat, one for pork, two for beef.
One. That's pork.
Yo,
that's pork, dude.
Dude, that guy's all dick.
China does not have enough pork. What on a dude?
I think they have plenty of pork.
Or is he Japanese? Where in Japan they might have enough pork.
That could be CGI pork, but it's still pork.
Oh,
pork porn.
Dude,
it's Photoshop fucking bacon.
Pork form?
pork porn.
It's photo bacon. Hey, primitive. Hey, bud, you spelled fucking saying wrong.
What's up with people good? No,
hey,
dude. That's one thing I appreciate you, Gravy. I noticed that the other day. I was like, you actually spell well.
Oh,
everybody
thank you.
Has forgotten how to spell. I don't know what it is, but everybody has forgotten. Good. Every word is like not even spelled the same anymore. And I've had enough. I'm just kidding. I haven't had enough.
Look at Mike. Mike
is that
told
what you
me
want? Huh?
To play this.
All
right. He told me to play
UFO?
This right now. Can you hear that?
Yeah. Another 6ix9ine video?
It is. Oh, dude, I gotta.
Dude, I think I saw a Hot Dog FPV shirt in that bitch.
Oh, dude. Shit.
That's wait, tight, dude.
That's a UFO, clearly.
That's Tekashi 6ix9ine.
We're being taken over.
Yep. Wait, this.
Yeah, this Hot Dog one. FPV shirt. I seen it.
There it
oh,
is.
Is that a FPV mic? Or a UFPV mic?
Look at Bot's face. He's so fucked.
The drip. Yo, salute the president, you fucks.
Yo, hold on. Everybody, drink the champ.
Drink the champ. Yo, champ is actually more of a champ than we ever believed. I love him.
Champion.
Here's a champ.
Cinnamon.
Dude, I love that. Oh my god.
That's good shit, Mike. When is it gonna be up? Fucking in 20 years? Oh! I always talk shit to Mike because he's like a perfectionist. And I'm like, bro, just upload it. Like, Joel, he's a perfectionist.
Hey, Mike, if you're in the chat, how did that hey, if you're in the if you're in the chat, how did that download work? Because I can't type.
Hey guys.
Oh my god.
Oh my god, it's Ian.
What is this picture on my computer? I don't understand.
Why is Ian hugging Old Mayo?
Oh wait.
Yo, that's not Neil. That is clearly hold on.
That's right before he gagged. Dude, he was gagging so bad with that man. But he found it so quick.
Dude, that's fucking awesome. Wait, where is it?
That might be the correct. That's the first picture we took of the night.
Not he's.
Wait, where's the one with me on it? You got that? I know you got that one.
I might. Hold on.
If you don't, I do.
Hold on. All right. Well, I mean, you can.
I don't know where. No, I don't know where it is. I mean,
I don't know where it is either. I've lost you. I've lost you, Gravy.
Oh, dude, I'm out, boys.
Oh, God. I don't have it.
Should we end on mayonnaise?
No. No. Wait, I have this one, though. You are in this one.
Oh, my God, that's so awesome.
Oh, my God. Do you have the Frosty with the Christmas tree?
Frosty with a Christmas tree as
wait,
well.
Oh, wait, hold on. Who the fuck is on the computer in the background?
That's some dude's son. He also had his nipples out.
All right. Oh, is that the guy that started the whole thing?
I think Smokey McNipples.
Oh,
is
let's
he still on the I'll chat? Or I'm going to send him a picture of this. So
yeah. Yep. Dude, he is definitely in the chat. I can't type to him because I'm blocked on my own one. But
Christmas tree. Oh, I didn't edit the Christmas tree. Somebody else did. That was the problem.
Dude,
different spot.
Frosty using the Christmas tree is his own dick. I wish he was here to see it.
Yo,
I have a good question. Oh, go ahead.
If Frosty didn't impregnate that Christmas tree, there would not be Christmas next year.
Then
I want you to just know that. I will find this picture. Fuck.
If it wasn't for Frosty, I would have one less tattoo.
Wait, what tattoo?
The Rotor Riot one. Because
that's right. It was in the Dabbin' Wagon.
Little camper thing.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, the Dabbin' Wagon.
The Dabbin' Wagon. That was fucking the wagon of everybody. Everybody was so cramped. Hey, yeah, I have a question for you guys. An actual good one. Wait,
okay.
I just forgot it. Oh, yeah, I remembered it. How long do you guys take to edit your average video?
Some of my videos I'll edit in a night. Some I'll take fucking months to edit. depends on like what I'm going for. If I'm going for like a quick edit or
like when you upload, how like you don't take like months on everything.
Not everything. It's like every 10th edit, I'll do like a big project that will take a lot longer than.
But
like,
are you uploading other ones like in?
Yes. Yeah.
So how long do those take?
I can like if I like sit down and I have like a little bit of B-roll and a little bit of flight footage and I have like a 3-4 minute song, I can do that in a night, no problem. Probably 3-4 hours.
How about you, old Greg? Like, don't fucking lie.
No, honestly, I'm slow. It takes me fucking forever to find a song. Are you talking before or after you find like the song you want to use?
That's a good question. does it take you? Well, I mean, with and without.
I mean, and it'll go. All right. It's taken me like 3 days to find the right song for an edit, but I mean, I can do an edit in like 6 or 7 hours because I don't know what the fuck I'm doing.
That's pretty good. How about you, Frosty? Just kidding.
Oh, hold on.
Quit trying to hide behind your memes.
Just kidding. Hold on.
That's who Edoc is. You cannot fault him.
Hold on. There we go. I don't know. Like,
a long time.
4 hours, maybe? 3-4 hours? And then if it's like a one that needs multiple days worth of shit, you know? Sometimes I feel like I need to put like 5 different spots for people to even want to watch it.
Sure.
Oh, you know what I mean? Like, so, like, your new video.
You can't like get it all in one day.
Right. That's what you said. No, but it's true though. I mean, or you know, yeah, it has to be compelling, like fun to watch at least, you know.
Yeah. Like, it's gotta be fun to watch.
I don't go. I try for fun
like
to
my
watch.
My goal is to like get people to watch my videos as long as possible. Like that's what I'm thinking about when I'm editing, is like, okay, is the first fucking 30 seconds good enough to hook them in? Is like the next minute enough to like continue to tell that story, and then like it's the next 3 or 4 minutes like enough to like really just like not get a bored, you know? That's fucking hard,
dude. Yeah. If I don't get a boner in the first 30 seconds, I'm out.
Exactly, that's what I'm saying. Dude,
but everybody's out in the first 30 seconds. That's the problem.
I was saying that earlier, like everybody bones out early.
If people would watch the whole video, they'd realize that they're missing out on on every fucking
there are those MVPs that watch the whole video. Like there's certain people that I watch like the whole fucking video, like no problem. Like, but that's like the hardest part is like humans have such a short attention span that it's like hard to fucking get them to watch your shit.
Well, and like even when you watch it though, that's the same thing, you know what I mean? Like you can be your own tester kind of. Like if it sucks, like if it sucks I'll skip through it, you know what I mean? If I feel like it has potential. Like I'll skip through and see if there's any, you know, or whatever.
Yeah, I won't end it, you know.
I don't watch flying at all. Like I used to watch flying. Like I just can't. It bores me. Like,
dude, I have like my the close homies that I have the fucking notifications bells on, and anytime I get a notification, I'll watch those videos right away.
Right,
like Zara.
But yeah, but if like not that, I don't go search for fucking FPV videos. I'll go search for like badass like premiere editing tutorial videos, or like Peter McKinnon or fucking, you know, JRLE, those guys, like I'll like go search their videos, but or I'll search the stupidest fucking shit ever, like shit that like will have me in a loop for hours, like Instant Karma videos. Oh man, dude, I'll get stuck in those videos. Or like work accidents. Oh my god, I love seeing idiots get hurt themselves. Yeah. I fucking love that.
It's all about the cut.
Yo, but Mike said in chat, no dead spots, keep their eyes busy. And, like, so check it. Like, yesterday I was editing a video. I sent it to Gravy to look at because, like, I'd never done an overlay to tell what parts I had on my quad. And I'm working on this video now where it's, like, in a spot where it's kind of like I'm doing a long-range push to the mountaintop, you know? And it's, like, I figure people are wanted to see the fucking 7-inch I just built fly. So I would just throw the parts on and it'd be like that. So then I was like, fuck it. You know, I had the 5-inch running over some ice, some wicked thin ice. like, might as well throw the parts on that too. So I picked the most boring part of the 5-inch flight, and I threw like a little side thing that told all the parts on the quad.
Uh huh. Uh-huh.
Yeah. I never.
This is what I challenge each of you guys to do, and I try to do that with each of my videos. Is every single video you do, do something that you do not know how to do that you haven't done in a previous video.
Export.
Dabber dabber.
Whether it be a different transition effect or a different editing technique, or, you know, like try something that's a little bit harder. Maybe like try some crazy frame masking, or just like always push yourself.
Yeah, every video is like a fucking new chance to learn something.
It, that's what I'm saying. That's what I do. And in any video I get, I like, I'm sitting down to make, I'm always like, okay, how the fuck, I can see what I want to do. I just don't know how to do it. How can I, you know, achieve this? And I'll sit there, and whether it takes fucking 20 tutorials or just me fucking around and making it look like crap 20 times, like, I'm going to figure out how to do it.
Yeah.
I always feel like I need more format, and then I always, like, I feel like I go against it because I always, I don't mind doing something different. Well, I'm not talking to, like, street flying and shit. But I kind of like when there's a format, when you kind of know, but then...
Well, you have to have your basic format so you can actually get your video done.
Right, and that's what I don't have. But I don't know. I kind of wish I did, but...
Well, okay, check this. But do you think that even the format gets old? So you got to change the format.
I think you can shape your channel by your format.
Well, it depends on what you really do. Too. Like,
okay, certain, well, like, I hear that. If you're like doing reviews and shit, that's
like format. When I talk about format, I'm like how your edit is compiled. You know, if it's like talking at the beginning, or if it's like straight into flight footage, or if you got your intro, you know, that you play every single time. You know, I'm still like honing in on my format, but I feel like I got it down. You know, like I'm either doing like a one pack, or like a mixed edit of like B-roll and flight footage, or like an over the top crazy edit that I've spent months on, you know. It's like one of those three.
A video where it's like Tupac music only, but it's also
dude, I was trying to do this the other day, but my quads were fucked. I was trying to do 5 quads, 1 pack each, and play like the best few seconds of each quad, cuz like all my quads fly way different. So I think it would be cool to like see that, you know.
Dude, you know, I feel like each of my quads is a different flavor. You know what I mean? And I can deploy the different flavors. You know what I'm saying?
Dude, exactly. I got one. I want to issue a challenge right now.
Yeah.
How about Zorro and Chris? You guys edit each other's fucking videos. Because
dude,
you guys
down to do a fucking edit swap with Zorro. I know, dude. Okay, Zorro, I was talking about this earlier. Your last, like, winner. I thought that was the coolest fucking shit ever. That's better than a fucking quad, dude, is, like, editing somebody's footage. Because that's what, like, your viewers want. You know, like, they watch your videos and they're like, man, I really like the way this guy makes fucking content. And to do that for your viewers, I think that's fucking awesome. So I'm like,
thank you. I'll do it for you, no problem.
Dude, I want to do that for my, when I hit 1,000, I want to do that as a giveaway rather than the fucking, you know, a quad that you can buy. Like, you can't buy your fucking time. You can't, you know, like,
well, you can actually.
Well, you can, but
hey, how much
Zorro's proven that
you can't buy a Zorro editing time from fucking Pyroflip, you know.
Well, then
why can't you
be contained in your container, son?
why can't you put a Zorro video in your cart on VHS?
Well,
I want all my videos on fucking VHS.
Dude, I'm what's working wrong? On
8-track, bud.
Yeah.
No, just but audio. Yo, but honestly, that'd be pretty fucking dope. Like, if you guys, because you guys can both fucking edit. You guys both know what you're doing.
Wait till I hit 1,000 subs, so I at least feel like I'm in the same ballpark with Zorro. I'm not in the same ballpark with him yet.
No, but we're all, I mean, just for fun.
We're in the homie ballpark. It doesn't matter.
Yeah,
homie
just park. We're all in UFDA ballpark.
EMT, hold on, you guys.
Yep.
Oh, he's taking it like a champ. Look at him. Blasting off, man! Look at him, bro. He's
out. No, that's a trick too. You got to hold it in. If you don't hold it in, you don't blast off.
Okay, so I'll raise the challenge. Is that Chris Teal? You have to try to edit like Zorro on his shit, and Zorro, you have to edit
That would be hard, dude.
You guys have to try to edit like somebody else. I think that would be fucking dope.
Yeah, make challenges on other people.
Sure, I can. I just did.
Each other's cars.
I just did. It's like you guys can drive each other's Volkswagens.
If I had a bunch of footage, I can put that together the way I put together footage. I'm sure Zora could do that the same way. But it's like,
you know, it'd be dope if you do one set of footages and then you do one and then I do one.
I think it would be cool. Like this is like I approached Icky with this a while ago, but yeah, I love Icky, but he seems up or down.
Should I invite Grumpy Trev?
Dude, invite him and ask him when Stu's putting out his next video because I'm getting antsy over here.
It's been 2 hours,
no. Bud. Okay, so rap battle. I think it would be cool to do like a rap battle video but with FPV footage.
You guys should just rap battle.
Everybody would. No,
you guys should just do a fucking rap battle.
It would be hard to figure it out, but I think that if done right, it could be cool.
Yeah, it's like a minute, maybe. A minute versus.
Maybe if you had like a song with like two different rappers and each verse, you know, anytime somebody would be rapping, like,
what if you guys,
the other person's fucking footage or something?
What if you guys edited each other's footage to the same fucking, like, content for music?
The same song? That would be cool.
Yeah, you put out the same.
With the same song?
Same song, and you have to edit each other's footage. Dude, Zoro, cool. You look so angry. I'm so sorry.
And you have to do it on DMT.
Yes. And bath salts.
And bath salts. Nicotine salts, bro.
Oh.
Thanks for reminding
me. Lunch me. What temp you dabbing on, hon?
All right. Well, I sent the link to Grumpy Trev. Everybody, dude. Get people watching. Grumpy Trev might show up anytime now.
Dude.
It's like, I don't know. It's almost time for him to be home from flying.
It's, I'll tell you right now, I have the world clock on my thing because I've been waiting for Steve.
Dude, it's like noon.
Is that the Ickyverse?
In Sydney, it's 5:30 p.m.
Look what I just found. You guys are horrible. I'm getting all these horrible texts from all these horrible people.
Why is everybody hold
on. Did you get that from Ian?
Give him the link. Give Ian the link.
What?
Where's Frosty?
No, he went to work.
Oh, Frosty's there. Give Frosty the link. I worked on some green screen shit with Frosty. I want to see it. I want to see it live.
Send it over, bud.
All right. Sending it to Frosty then. Frosty, can you handle this?
I still love that Chris looks like a fucking optical illusion.
I know. He's like the same color as the background.
Dude. I still have to eat dinner, and it's like fucking 2 in the morning.
Hey, I got a burrito before work, and I never ate it, and it's going to be so fucking good in like half an hour.
What kind of burrito? A breakfast burrito or like a regular burrito?
Not like a regular chicken burrito.
DJ Lunchmeat said, hold on, I'm dead.
Hold on.
So do we
Everybody cheers? Hold on.
Do we cheers to him?
All right, fine.
I'm holding.
Guys, my cheers are way more dangerous.
Yes! It's your turn, bud.
Oh, look at him. He's having a super time.
Mm. Can you see that badass sticker I got?
Oh, shit. Is that LSD?
It looks like a tab acid.
Dude, backwards it's cone. What?
Oh, you know, trippy.
Cone. What? I just solved the puzzle. Matt needs to go eat. He's tripping. He's not wearing pants. Can't hear.
Yeah, nope. Right. Yo, I think. Nope, we're reconnected.
Yo, DJ Lunchmeat, is your nail hot enough? Is that how you do it? Oh, shit, okay. It's ready.
Oh, shit, look at those. You know what? There aren't any more of those, Matt. You got all of them.
I did.
Yeah.
They've been in my butt.
Who's this DJ Lunchmeat? He wants to join the mid chat. Send him the fucking link.
How do we send him the link?
But you gotta talk. You can't just be up here and just like listen.
Yeah.
And watch like TV on the side and shit.
And if you say one wrong word,
fucked up thing, you're out.
Yeah,
go and on. Don't even get your feelings hurt because this shit ain't for real.
Yeah, we don't have
this
feelings.
This shit ain't for real.
Dude, if you got a legit cam and a legit mic, fucking hit up Chris Teal on Facebook or fucking Matt Williamson.
Nah, don't hit me up, dude. I got so much other shit
hit
I'm
up
running.
Matt Williamson with dick pics and everything.
Oh, yeah, that's fine. I'll look at them later, but don't hit me up, like, for live stream stuff, because I'm, like, monitoring all kinds of values.
Guys, we definitely need more people to watch, so I just want
to... Waxfire wants the link, too.
Call out to everybody, like, for real. Hey, let's just bump
dude,
this up.
Gravy, make me mod if you need to go to bed soon and just start... Fucking shoving the link out.
No, hey, I man, can't. No, I've done tired. That.
This is, it's Christmas.
Hold on. I've done that before and I've Hanukkah. Gone to bed. But you have to remember that, you have to remember I'm the one that's hosting this, the whole fucking thing. So if I go to bed, it'll go, oh, well, I guess I can let it go till the fucking morning again. We had people that were, we had people that were
I'm
watching.
Telling you, bro, watch time minutes.
Yeah. Yeah,
Gravy, you could just put up a cool picture, go to bed, and then we're good, right?
Just put on a fucking loop. Just hit VLC and put it on a loop of one of your vids and just gain your fucking viewership, bro.
Yeah, bro. Get your shit.
Yeah.
He's like, I
we're
could.
Going all night till the Australians wake up.
Ooh.
I thought you said it was like 5 o'clock in the afternoon.
Till the Australians are done doing stuff.
Matt, why is there smoke like floating in your room? Is that like a ghost or is that is that a cigarette?
Oh no.
Can I have one?
No.
Can everybody that smokes have a cigarette right now? For those of us who don't smoke? Perfect, thank you.
It's
oh my god. I keep having dreams that I smoke, dude. For the past week I had like 3 and I wake up and I'm like, oh shit. And last night I had one.
You all was Zorro?
Yeah.
There you go.
What?
There you
and then I was thinking, well, it's just one. Like in my dream, I'm like, it's just one. I'm not gonna start smoking. And then I woke up and I was like, oh, that was a fucking thing. So I win, I guess. Not really. But yeah, it sounds fun. But you know, it's bad for you. I mean, you guys are fine because you're not super fat like I am. But it's not good for me.
Oh, dude, I went out tonight.
I'll say this, my fucking dad, he fucking smoked cigars, like Swishers, like cigarettes, my entire childhood. Like that's just how I grew up, you know? Dude, and he was always drinking beer, too. He was 6 months without fucking drinking anything, like, last week?
Cheers?
And, like, yeah, like, for sure. Like, it's crazy. Like, the last time I was visiting him, he, like, kept cracking open Mountain Dews, and I, like, looked down, expecting it to be a beer, and it was not a beer. And it was just, like, a mind fuck. Mm-hmm. It's fucking crazy.
Dude, it's funny. I started, like, using this dab pen. I'm like, yeah, I'm gonna quit, like, drinking, like, beers, and I'm gonna be good. And it was like, no, now I'm just using a fucking dab pen and still fucking drinking the same fucking amount. And it's not good.
I'm going to send a link to Gearhead. He's the dude. He's been fucking mad following my shit. So I got
to... Oh, so we all have to fucking pay the price?
Yes. Yes. Yes.
Oh,
yes,
let me get throw my subs on here too, I guess. Oh, look at Ian on here. He's funny.
Yeah, get... Let's just... Have a fucking...
Ian. Yo, if you...
Ian.
You might be at work. What's today? Tuesday?
Not
at work today.
Not anymore, I guess.
He works late sometimes. Talking about Ian.
Ian just went to work. Angry eyebrows.
You know what's funny? Everybody calls him EJ. Like, everybody. And I saw his name as Ian, so I've always called him Ian. And now everybody knows him as Ian. And he really goes by EJ. It's kind of like DJ and Bob Grinder.
Son of a like bitch. That. So it's EJ and DJ? What?
EJ the DJ.
Ooh, DJ Lunchmate's trying to fucking get a Lumix G7, dude. That's such a nice fucking camera, dude. I rock a $400 cheap ass fucking Nikon D3400. Go to Best. I don't even think they sell it anymore.
An idiot,
dude.
Yeah, you do the GoPro style like fucking perfect, dude.
Dude, so like a
no, dude, like your style, just like your like goofy, like I don't even know, dude. It's fucking badass. I like the way your style of looks.
I can get it in a lot. That's what she said. But that I can get it places where I don't feel like everybody's looking at me. So it makes yeah. Like,
dude, I can't bring my DSLR everywhere, dude.
No.
Dude, what's up, Gearhead?
Oh, it's Gearhead.
Yo, I'm still shooting with a fucking a Pentax SLR. So you guys are like way above me. I'm still shooting film.
Yo, UAV Futures just posted.
No, he didn't.
DJ and
yes,
Western
he did. Story. Yes, he just posted. Yes, you guys. I just posted
it. Fuck yeah.
Watch it. Oh my god. Dude.
What do you
fuck yeah?
I'm oh my god.
Yo,
I'm putting the fucking link in chat.
I fucking have been waiting for this, dude.
I just hit up Trev, so it's like maybe Trev will get on and fucking.
Dude. Okay, I'm not listening to you guys. I'm watching this video.
Yeah.
No, wait.
What
no.
video? Why are we watching it?
Let's watch it right now.
No, wait.
Bring
hold
it up.
On.
Bring it up.
Yeah,
bring
I'm bringing it up right now.
Bring it up. Let's watch it together, you guys. This is fucking. Dude.
What's the video? Just so I know.
No.
What is it? He's announcing the winner of his contest.
Everybody go give it a view.
Woo!
Give it away.
What
it's
I
like
really
a million
want
dollars?
You to do
why
is
everybody so excited?
I want
HDOs,
to spread the link.
A quad and a radio and a full crossfire system.
Oh my
All right,
god.
Here we go.
Here we go.
Dude, I don't care. Dude, I've been waiting.
Here it is.
Dude. All right,
we did, boys.
Ready?
Mm-hmm.
Gravy, I got the audio if you want.
Is that too loud?
We need the audio, yeah.
Great, he's playing. Here, I'll just play it along.
What's a fucking video, eh?
Yeah, I can't see.
Here, watch my...
The Spoonie J and West Side Story. It's a West Side Story, it's boys.
Do people have to put videos up to compete?
It ended like November 1st. It's been a while.
Oh, great. I'm sure. I'm glad I didn't know.
Dude, this is so sick.
Yo, hold on. Yo, congrats. Cheers, everybody. Dude, fuck yes. Congrats to you and Spoonie.
Yeah.
Fuck yeah. It's fucking history right now, boys.
Or no.
Oh, yeah.
Smooth fucking shots that did it, bro.
Dude, I was shooting these shots before he even put out the fucking contest. I was like, I want to make a badass edit, but I don't know what to shoot. Dude, can I shoot like just a bunch of footage of you? He's like, yeah, man. And then like this contest came out, and he's like, dude, like let's just fucking use all the footage we've been using. I'm like, well, fucking fuck yeah.
Fuck yeah, dude, that's awesome. Several times and stabilized for days. This is the winning video, isn't it?
Yeah, dude. He's like, oh, this is so sick.
As 2017 awesome, began, dude. I was struggling to find something to bring purpose to my life. I play a lot of video games. I tried to get back into old hobbies. Everything I did reminded me of my life before, the one riddled with drugs and depression. And this went on for most of last year. Sometime in September, I stumbled across FPV drone racing while watching YouTube. I was drawn in by the fast-paced action and the sensation of flying. After looking deeper into this awesome new hobby, I saw a video titled FPV Drone Racing for under $300. I bought everything on the list and started practicing on a simulator while I waited for my Yixin Wizard X220 to arrive in the mail. I flew every day, recharging one battery between flights. I was instantly hooked. I found what I was looking for. Something to keep my attention, a creative outlet. I was content, and I didn't think it could get any better. And that's when I met my first friend in the hobby. I didn't know that there was anyone in my town that was flying these things, because I had shut down all of my social media accounts in October 2016 after leaving the hospital. No Facebook, no Twitter, no Instagram, no Snapchat. So I didn't know that there was anyone else in Grand Junction that flew RC quads. So I searched YouTube, and that's when I found Chris. Mr. Westside FPV. I dropped my phone number and a comment on one of his videos, and I received a text shortly after. When we met, I was nervous, and that's because I don't ever like feeling like the noob. But Chris never made it about that. He was just super willing to share whatever he could. Skills, tools, parts, whatever. He just wanted to make it fun and get another drone up in the air. Fast forward a year. October 2018. I have so many friends based around this hobby that I have met through Chris. People that share my interest in these awesome little flying machines. I feel a part of something, and I now can contribute spare parts, tools, skills to help others, because at the end of the day, it really is just people helping people, but it's based around an awesome, adrenaline-packed, addicting hobby.
Yeah, I had to actually redo the fucking audio for him.
Yeah, the video's on your page, and I can't... just do exclamation point west side.
I honestly bet everybody here has watched the video, so... if you haven't, head over to my channel and just... You can honestly actually just search Drones Changed My Life on YouTube and you'll find it. And it's got the actual audio and full sound effects and... But yeah, that means, I want to watch the last part of the video because he might actually say something about...
Oh, yeah. Also, Gearhead didn't say anything, and the rule was he has to say something or he's getting kicked out. So Gearhead... Yeah,
no. Gearhead, dude, where's my shit? Where's it at?
Come on, Gearhead, take that back.
I need to send Zoro one of my hook things.
Yes.
Oh, yeah, dude, the retrieval thing?
Dude, yeah. That's so good.
Oh, my God. Yeah,
I got, hey, Virgin.
I got 10 of them here for Mike.
Oh my God, I will make Mike's, the belt that shoots that thing out.
If Mike's in the chat, I'm getting these things ready to ship.
These things are right. I've been sitting here watching. Come on, fucking go to Gearhead.
That's amazing. How do I hook up with the Gearhead? Facebook? Are you on Facebook?
I'm trying to get everybody on UFDA crew one of these things.
Dude.
Dynamite?
Dude, fuck yeah. Thank you for that, man. That's a lot of fucking hooks.
Yeah, that's awesome.
Alright, I guess so. Yeah, he doesn't say anything in the end. He just says, thanks to Spoony Jane Westside for letting me share their winning story of how drones change their life. That's all cool. Right.
So...
I got HDOs, boys. What kind of module should I get?
Oh, yeah, you got all kinds of shit now.
Clearview or Rapid Fire? No, the question.
Rapid Fire.
That's what I'm thinking.
You got to get it.
Rapid View.
Rapid View.
Yes. Rapid View, yes.
UFDA Viewer. That's what we're going to come out with our own module. Stay out of fucking fear.
I just got one of the new hot dog straps.
Dude, whoa. They're so good, right?
It is awesome.
Bit. Yeah. Dude.
I don't know why I waited this
what
long.
What size? What size? 2-inch?
Yeah, I got the 2-inch. I got the chin one.
Butt chin.
Yeah.
Fuck yeah.
Hell
Dumb for it, boys. I'm just kidding.
Dude, fuck yeah, dude. Congrats, Chris. You must be on fucking top of the world right now, dude.
Dude, I'm fucking stoked, dude. That's dude, cool. That's like, awesome. That's like the biggest thing I've like gotten for doing just like really nothing, you know, just like what I like to do.
Well, you dude. Did it. You did the work up front.
You did it well. Yo, you are such a good fucking video editor. You're such a good pilot. You're not just hitting one fucking checkbox.
I think what really set me above was like, I just live in a badass spot where I have like access to cool places to fly. I think the cool places to fly really like, and dude, me having like cool friends too. Like I couldn't do this without cool friends. Like I think that's what's up with the Icky right now. You know, like he's all sad, but I just think he doesn't have anybody cool to fly with. Because it's never dull if I have a good like homie to go like, and I got a bunch to go rip with, you know.
Mm.
I only have one, and that's Ian. And,
well, doesn't he make it like a million times better?
Yeah. Oh yeah, totally.
It makes everything better. Everybody makes it a trillion times better.
Dude, it's like I'm looking forward to flying with Enoch all year because like that's the only dude that apparently is gonna fly with me all year.
I don't stop flying because of a fucking thing called winter.
Dude, yeah, same here.
Winter can suck it.
Yeah, I don't fly with anybody else.
I'll show you how much winter can suck it. Hold on, dude. I bought something for them.
Oh, Eric, you have to find somebody out there and get them fucking hooked. And you have to fucking fly with them.
I've got a few guys that have drones around here, but nobody, every time I call them or get a hold of them, they're like, no, hey. Something.
Call him more.
Show him your cool hooks.
I want to go see Kit. Yeah. Kit's only about 3.5 hours away.
Dude, go see him. He's a good fucking dude.
Yeah.
Dude, Aaron, like, I'm on the same page. If I live closer to Icky, like, I would totally be his friend. Because, like, we're on the same page, but...
Go fly with people.
Yeah, man. That's what it's about. Like, at the end of the... Like, the last sentence of that video is, like... Get out there, find a local flying club, and go see why FPV saves lives. Because, dude, like, straight up, like, I was, like, in a weird rut. Like, I love, like, the things I was doing. I was growing weed and, like, DJing and shit. But I still felt like there was, like, something missing as far as, like, my technical side. Because I really like doing things with my hands and, like, building. And but I also like doing extreme stuff. Like, I was doing, like racing dirt bikes and shit. But I fucking... didn't like wrecking and hurting myself. And dude, FPV was just like that perfect medium. I can like do like my creative side with like the video editing, plus it still got the like the adrenaline rush of racing dirt bikes.
Yeah,
dude, it's like a perfect medium for a lot of like industries, and the more people realize it's like the actual thing you can do for not that expensive, like the more people are gonna like. It's crazy. Like I hear all these like horror stories of people getting stopped at parks or whatever, and you know, I read one today about some dude almost getting in a fight. You know, somebody didn't like him flying at the park he was at. I've never had that happen. Like, 99% of the time, it's somebody, like, walking by, like, asking to put the goggles on because they think it's so fucking cool. Yep. And then the other 1%, it's, like, something about their dog or just, like, some dumb shit, and it's gone within, like, 5 seconds, and you forget about it, you know?
Yep. I definitely had an old lady like come and berate me with my goggles on while I was flying a 6S.
Yeah, but she also asked you which quad you were flying in your last video.
No. This is a different lady. This is at a pond, and this lady came up. I was like flying over trees because there was kind of like an incline and some like vines. So I was flying around the vines and over these trees behind the vines, and she came up screaming at me about taking video of her. And then before I could really react, because like I was like, what in the fuck do I do, you know, because I got a 6S going 100 miles an hour over there, you know. So I just kept flying and ignored her, and then within like a couple seconds this really cute chick came up and started screaming at her, saying that I'm not watching her. She's so stupid.
Yeah, did you get that cute chick's number or anything?
Yo, I was gonna, but check it. Right then, like, she was there at the pond to meet up with somebody, ends up being the older brother of my ex-girlfriend.
Even better, dude. You have an in.
Right.
Unless that was all bad.
It was a little weird. It was a little weird.
Dude, that chick was awesome.
She was awesome. She saved me from the old lady, kind of like if she touched me, I could have crashed at 100 miles an hour.
Yeah.
You know? But like random pedestrian comes in and
that's awesome.
Fuck up for FPV.
We need more people like that.
Right?
Yeah. Fucking old ladies, man. I swear to God. Are there any old ladies that fly FPV?
There should be. We need to get old ladies into FPV.
They're
you know what? But like Gravy did have a story. Like my neighbor did say, if I fly over her house, she'd shoot the drone out of the sky.
But then she heard those MB Primos and she was just like, I really like that one.
No.
She likes the
she
blue
heard
one.
The MB Primos. And then she called me up and she said, hey, I like the blue one better.
Yes, it's just better.
This is the MB Primo motor.
Dude, look at them 2208s. Look how tall those fuckers are. Not wide, tall. Ooh. Those are tall bitches.
I look tall.
Dude, you know, she loves this because it's got these blue LEDs on the bottom.
Yeah.
Oh, she likes that. She likes that. Yeah. You should find an endangered animal, tie it to your quad at the bottom. Don't kill it. Fly it over her house. Have her shoot it. Kills endangered.
No. Okay.
Call up the fucking government.
She likes guns, and she likes animals. So she's an animal person and a gun person.
So she'd offer.
Yeah, she hates drones.
She'd offer herself after shooting the endangered species. Right on.
The blue one is okay.
The perfect fucking perfect story.
Don't drone shame us, lady.
I'm gonna email Stu right now and tell him thank you because that's fucking cool.
Tell him we all said hi.
I tried messaging him and it blocked it.
Hey,
he's hard to get a hold of, but he's been like I've been having a steady email chain with him, and that feels kind of cool because he was like one of the first videos I've like came across, and you know now like
dude, UAV Futures is a good channel.
Dude, Stu is a bad motherfucker, dude. Yeah. I don't necessarily agree with like all the shit that he says. The content that he puts out is unbeatable. Like, dude, it just makes you want to fly fucking drones watching him because he's just like. Yep. Yeah, g'day, mate. Like,
gotta take it with a grain of salt because, like, he is reviewing a fuck ton.
Yeah,
He doesn't have time to really.
Much.
Like the way we review stuff is gonna be different.
We'll fly it for a fucking month and like critique it. He'll fly it twice and be like,
every way you can break it.
Yeah, and I get it. Like, that's why he's good. It's because it's that first initial opinion, and that's really what you're looking for.
Yeah.
No, but that gives you a enough.
It gives you a baseline to where you can, you know.
And then,
dude, the Dead Cat, look, Bleakus is talking about the Dead Cat quad. Like, the Dead Cat quad is my preferred setup. But the reverse. It's 5-inch arms in the front, 6-inch in the back, running 5-inch props. That's my secret sauce, FYI, y'all.
Damn.
And on that note, we should end this because I have to eat dinner at 2 a.m.
You're such a wussy nowadays, man. I swear to God.
I know. That's what I'm saying. I remember when this shit was going until 5 fucking a.m.
You used to be a party animal, dude.
Dude,
party
if you want.
Animal.
I think you don't have to work tomorrow. I got to work fucking early tomorrow,
bud.
We're celebrating.
Cat.
No, Gravy. I want to go fly tomorrow. That's why.
Gravy, put up the cats and just leave it.
Dude, yeah.
Hold on.
Under Stu's main audience is noobs. And honestly, that's kind of what I thought. And I wouldn't have found out about that contest if it wasn't for Spirit J.
I mean, all the cats.
No,
the menagerie of cats.
Well, no, that's RNG. That's the one that doesn't come home. That's him. Hey,
welcome home, brother.
Fucking RNG, fucking Ricky's goldfish.
Yep.
Dude, if you guys don't know about Trailer Park Boys, go just put it on Netflix and just. Yeah. Hit fucking go and just let it go through the whole all seasons.
Wait.
Hit go or hit play?
Listen, if you're going to do the Trailer Park Boys thing, I do think it's.
Start on season 3.
It's 4. Cool. No. Check it. It's cool if you can force yourself to watch two season three, because check it, it gets rolling. You know what I mean?
It does. But I would say if you really like don't know what it is, just start at season three. Once you hit like season five, you're gonna be like, I need to know more about their origin, and then you're gonna go back to season one and just fucking go through it.
So go from season three to season five, back to one.
Yo, but also randomly throughout the seasons, you gotta stop and watch a movie.
Yes, the Trailer Park Boys movies. Yes.
Yes. Three, they got movies.
Because it ties in with them.
Three
like
movies.
What the one? It's Trailer Park Boys, the movie, and then the second one is Countdown to Liquor Day. Third one is, fuck, I just had it in my head.
It's like don't something about the bad guys.
Yeah. Hey. No, that's like an in between movie.
Hey, can I just point out that I definitely sent Grumpy Trev a Zoom link to our YouTube live stream called "I Swear to God I Will Haunt Every Toilet Wombat UFDA Crew Shit Show."
Yo, so let's drink the fucking wombat because
it's so beautiful. That is so beautiful,
dude. He's in a bad spot. His butt sucks.
Yeah, he's bleeding out of his butthole. Reaper X, if you don't know, if I like all my shit is houndstooth.
Hell yeah.
In honor of fucking Ricky. There's some West Side Edition hot dog FPV straps right here. If you want an indestructible strap. Look at that fucking loop. Dude, yeah. That thing ain't not breaking. I could tow my truck with that.
Burberry's lawyers want to talk to you.
I could tow my balls with that.
Burberry. You know what Burberry is?
All right. And we're going to call it because I have to fucking
eat. Bye, everybody.
I got to eat. Dude, congrats.
Matt has to eat and he has to sleep, apparently.
Congrats.
I guess I should too.
Congrats to Chris Teal. He's up super late.
Congratulations.
So,
thanks for watching.
Thank all you guys. Yeah. Yes.
The cinnamon's getting me.
Cinnamon's getting you.
Yeah.
Night, boys.